deadline, and you know, we know exactly who they are, and they know exactly who we are. So it's about the guys executing the game plan, and I'm sure that there's going to be some tight hockey games here, and you know, one bounce either way can determine the outcome.
I know it's a new series, Mike, a different opponent, but you got to be happy with your 5-on-5 play. Knock on wood, didn't give up a single 5-on-5 goal in the opening series. It only gave up 3 goals total. I mean, we talked about how good your team was defensively this year, and that was certainly one of the key ingredients to the 4-game sweep.
Yeah, I agree with you, Hardy. I mean, I didn't think we'd be as good as we were 5-on-5. I mean, that's pretty incredible that we didn't give up one goal, you know, even strength here. But it is definitely something that we talked about before the series. You know, we wanted to kind of get back to who we were as a team that defended so well and played hard in our own end. And we did a great job of that. And, you know, Laser deserves a lot of the credit there. He played real good in the first round. And, you know, real proud of, you know, his play. And I think he's got to feel good about himself. You know, again, you talk about momentum. I think as a goaltender, you probably, you know, don't want that long layoff after feeling so good about yourself. But, you know, we're real confident in him and our ability to defend.
No Alexei Silvestri tonight, Mike, but you've preached depth all along and the other guys. So, I mean, it's good. It's the tough thing is, obviously, an elite player, but he was really carrying the team offensively, especially the first two home games this rink. I mean, he was electric between him and Walker. I think he scored 7 goals between them in the 2 games.
Yeah, you know, obviously, we'd love to have Alexei in the lineup, but listen, if you can't win hockey games without one player, I mean, you don't deserve to win a championship. So, you know, I know that they're missing one of their good depth players that was a big part of their run last year, and actually a couple guys that are a little bit banged up on their team that are playing here tonight. So, I mean, it's the time of year, and, you know, thankfully Alexei's not hurt. It's just the suspension, and we'll have him back in the lineup tomorrow night.
We know that special teams are a big part of things. I thought a pretty good job being disciplined, Mike. I mean, you know you're going to get your power play chances to strike, but very important to stay out of the box, and even more important against, let's face it, battle for power play a little bit stronger than a Kinnersley power play. No disrespect to them.
Yeah, I agree with you. I was, you know, somewhat happy with it. I thought we took probably 4 or 5 undisciplined penalties in that series. You know, they didn't cost us, but it is definitely something we talked about. You know, I not to harp on Weyburn or anything like that, but, you know, their season gets ended by taking, you know, 3 penalties in the third period against a humble team that, you know, their power play wasn't, you know, really clicking at the time. And, you know, you give good teams opportunities, they're going to make you pay. And, you know, it's something that we've preached here for a number of years, is that you can't just flick a switch with the discipline.
I know the Flint-Flon-Estevan matchup, Mike, is a really good rivalry, but I think the Flint-Flon battle for one's pretty good, too.
Yeah, definitely. You know, they got some passionate fans over there, and of course we do as well. And, you know, you see the banter online and stuff like that, and I think it's good for the SJHL. You know, these two teams have had a lot of success over the last, you know, 10 years, and, you know, it's just fitting that we're matching up again.
Sounds good to me, Mike. Good luck in Game 1 of the SPHL semifinal tonight.
Thanks very much, Robert.
Mike Gregan, the head coach of the Bombers, once again here on 102.9 CFBR and FlintFawnOnline.com. Flint Fawn wished the Flint Fawn Bombers the best of luck the rest of the way now that they're in the SJHL semifinals, and are also excited to announce their cold brew lineup. Cold brew made with Arabica beans that are cold brewed to create that smooth cold coffee experience served over ice. The lineup includes the French vanilla cream cold brew, the caramel cream cold brew, sweetened cold brew with cream, a cold brew with a sugar-free syrup and cream, and the smooth vanilla soft serve with pieces of milk chocolate swirled together with a delicious flavor of a sweet cream egg. Available now at your local McDonald's in Flint Flon. Don't forget, drive-thru open daily at 7 a.m.
You're on.
SJHL Coaches Show continues. Of course, a familiar friend and a familiar, of course, comrade of the SJHL, Braden Kowalsko, joins us. Braden, we're just chatting. 6 meetings since 2016, and of course, met in the final this past spring. So we talked about it when I saw you in Battleford, which I guess would have been about a month ago. You knew this meeting was going to happen at some point, and, well, round one tonight.
Crazy. Yeah, it's seems like we meet every year, and Hardy, it's a familiar foe. Looking forward to it.
Talk about your first round series, kind of like the Bombers kind of lifted a little bit, 4-5-1 in your last 10, but able to play some pretty good hockey. I mean, let's face it, Melville, pretty good hockey club. They don't score a ton, but they certainly don't give up very much either. The 7 goals that you gave up in 4 games, is that among the bright spots for you in that series?
For sure. You know, it's funny, Hardy. We both play each other here late February. We're thinking, yeah, we feel good about both our games, and then all of a sudden we both go kind of on a skid. But, yeah, it's kind of one of those series that you get your feet underneath you. You know what playoff hockey is all about, and it's probably what the doctor ordered, to be honest. A full like that made it stingy on the defensive side, maybe really focused in on that aspect of it, and it was a good performance by our group.
You know, you're the defending champs until somebody beats it. I know maybe not quite the powerhouse you had last year, but still a lot of good hockey players on this team, and led by Kian Bell. And I mean, like I said to you before, and like I said on my blog today, reminds me of Wayne Gretzky in the 80s. I haven't seen anybody put up points like he does. And the good thing about him, not just the regular season, he's still getting the playoffs as well. 10 points, 5 goals. Wow. He just continues to impress, doesn't he?
Absolutely, yeah. It's amazing what he's able to do. And I think the one thing we were all concerned about when we got him back, like there was no Holden Dole or Southie to play with him, how he was going to be. And still finds a way. You know, he finds a way to put the puck in the net for us. And, you know, it's a big reason why we are where we are is because of him.
Here's a question. Is he better this year than he was last?
It's not even close. For sure he is. Yeah, there's not a question, you know. And at times it was probably easy for him last year. There's nothing that came easy for him this year. So definitely better this year in all aspects of his game. Defensively, you know, leader, like everything about it. He's just matured as a hockey player and as a human.
It just shows you what the playoffs are like. It's a totally different season. Were you a little concerned with how your team went in the postseason, or was maybe kind of rebound by the media and found out there maybe to be a little bit worse than what it was?
A little bit of both. You know, I think you, anyone that's been here, like I'm sure, you know, Regs would talk about it too. It's been a long season, and you know, you got your veteran guys that are just dying for that playoff type of feel, and we lived in for sure. And was I concerned? Absolutely I was, but you know, I also knew that we were going to be a lot better, and it showed in that first round. So after seeing the free game one, I knew we were going to be good.
Got a start in flip on this time. Normally you have home ice advantage. Does it make any difference to you?
Yeah, of course it does. You know, it'd be nice to be at home. You know, we feel a little bit more comfortable there than here, but it is what it is. You're going to have to at least win one here anyway, so, you know, maybe it can be tonight.
Is there talk on the bus? I mean, it's a long way from Battleford to Flint Fun about how the season wound up there. Of course, you won your championship right in this building here just a few months ago. Was there a lot of talk about that, or is that just kind of something the guys have forgotten about it, maybe a memory to talk about another day?
Yeah, you know what, guys feel comfortable, more comfortable here than years past. You know, obviously with the success we had last year always helps. You know, you could tell there was a difference, the different vibe with our group, even the first time we came up here during the season. You know, it wasn't quite as, we didn't quite have the nerves that we had before. So I think it's just helped us in some regards that still got to play the game. You can't worry about what the fans or anyone else does around you. You just got to play the game and really focus in on the ice.
You know, you have a lot of success here as a coach, but a lot of success as a player. What do you remember coming here as a player with the Broncos back in the day? What jumps into your mind?
You know what, it's funny. A few of the guys back home are asking about some of the fans that are still there. The one guy with the afro back in the day, he still comes to games. Like, it's so cool. It's something that you'll always remember and you always cherish. And, you know, a lot of stories I'd love to tell on the mic here, but we can't because they're, you know, a lot of derogatory terms or whatever. But it's been so much fun. You know, you should be proud of your organization, proud of your community, proud of your rink that you guys have. You guys take so much pride in it. You know, you got guys, you know, wiping the glass, you're getting the ice ready. It's just, there's such a focus to detail here that you guys should be really proud of what you guys have here.
And we talk about the atmosphere, how great it is, but I've talked to players and coaches from visiting teams. They quite enjoy the as a player, you can't help but get into it when it's jacked up. We know it's going to be jacked up again this weekend.
Absolutely. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be lots of fun. I'm looking forward to it, Hardy. Hopefully you guys are too. It's going to be one heck of a series.
One last thing, Brayden. I know that it was a little bit of a question mark about goaltending down the stretch, but Cunningham, lights out numbers the first. Did he go beyond expectation for you?
No, you know what, he was going through the same stretch as everyone else on our team. You know, just a little bit of a funk and a little lack of a bit of confidence. And we've seen it before where he's been really good for us, and you know, it's showing that first round.
Listen, Brayden, great to catch up with you. Good luck in the series, and the defending champs till somebody beats you. So great to see you back in the Final Four again. Good luck tonight. Good luck throughout the series.
Thanks, Artie.
There he is, Brayden Clemons. Of course, does a phenomenal job in the Battleford Stars. Like you mentioned, 2 league titles as a head coach in 4 years, won a national championship as a player with a member of the coach out on both Broncos. A lot of success, got a hockey pedigree. Greg McCaffrey, whatever, just announcing they're giving out the player awards here tonight. Noah Hult receiving the SPHL Defenseman of the Year. What a year Noah Hult, of course, had in the regular season. And like Connor Braden just mentioned downstairs, one of the best seasons for a Flint Bond Bomber, for a Bomber defenseman in a long, long while. He was incredible, just had a wonderful year. It was a pleasure to watch, and very well deserving, of course, of taking home that big victory this year. So Noah Hult once again, the SPHL Defenseman of the Year. Noah Hult leading all point getters with 68 points in 52 games.
CS operations in Creighton District.
And they're handing out another trophy here. Of course, Mike Reagan was selected the SPHL Coach of the Year. He'll get his award here tonight. And the top goaltender award, of course, to Harmon Laser Hume, and we saw what he did in the first round.
Absolutely, Harmon Laser Hume. You know what, especially those first two games, as we kind of mentioned, him and the Bomber team in general kind of had a few bumps down the road near the end of the season, but that first series, and especially those first two games, definitely a huge confidence boost from Harmon Laser Hume. 12 goals for, 0 goals against, and just an absolute performance from him. And you know what, when people see a shutout, sometimes they think, you know, it has to do with, oh, maybe he didn't get any, that many good shots or this or that, but he had a lot of pressure from that Kittredge team in all four games and just did an outstanding job at holding his composure and absolutely proving why he deserved to be the goalie of the year.
Kyle McIntyre, the SJHL commissioner downstairs presenting the trophies. Adam McCart's out there as well on behalf of SaskTel. And Harmon Laser Hume, what a year he had. One of the top, and the thing with Laser Hume was he's consistent throughout the entire season. He was great up from the beginning of the year, of course, right up until the end of the season.
I'm calling with the Saskatchewan Construction Safety Association, the Red Cross sponsor of the SJHL Coach of the Year Award.
So here comes the award for Mike Reagan.
Mike instills so many of the values in his athletes that we share at the Saskatchewan Construction Safety Association. And Mike, I'm really sorry I couldn't be there in person to present this award to you, but so I've asked somebody if they can handle that for me. You know what, they never ask how, they just ask how many. And you know, it's been 17 years, so we figured it's about time to be one. So, anyways, hey, congratulations, Mike. Really appreciate you. You know, you're a good kid from a good family, so I'm really glad that you got this.
Well, the announcement. Mike Reagan was about to get his trophy. The jumbo from?
Someone for the SCSA is what he said, but not too exactly sure.
Anyway, Mike, well deserved. He's had a great hockey club here for 17 seasons. Never missed the postseason. Been in the league finals for the last 6 years, and very well deserving as he selects the first ever Bomber head coach to win this award.
Wow, and like you said, 17 years in the making, marked a 500th regular season win this year, and just an outstanding career so far, not only as a player, but now as a coach of the Flint Bond Bombers. And, you know, just he's done so much for this community, and like you said, 17 years, I think it's finally well deserved. We probably could have had it some other years, but this was the year he got it. You know, couldn't be more deserving.
Absolutely. So Mike Reagan, the SJHL Coach of the Year, Harmon Laser Hume, the Goalie of the Year, and Noah Hult, the SJHL Defenseman of the Year. Nice way to hand out these trophies, getting ready for this big, big game 1-7, a big first game of the best of seven SJHL semifinal.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Perfect time to do it. It sets the tone for the team, for the whole crowd, and like I said, just a great honor for all the players and the coach to receive it.
We'll break for the anthem. We'll come back with the Bailey Holmes Builders of the Game momentarily.
Oh, Canada, we
First game of this SKHL semifinal. Here are the home builders of the game for the football Bombers up front. Justin Lees, he'll be joined up there with Gilbert, as well as Cohen Sets. This is a little bit of an interesting trio. Tanchuk and Anthony Bax, the veteran Ethan, will start things off on the back end. We mentioned Harmon Laser Hill, of course. What he did in the regular season, he's been absolutely lights out in the playoffs. We mentioned his numbers earlier. We'll get to him again because they're worth bringing up again. Harmon Laser Hill once again. Almost perfect, giving up just 3 goals in 4 hockey games in the opening series. Goals against him, 0.75, save percentage of 975. Rylan Williams, the terrific young rookie for the Stars, will start things off with Metternak, as well as Anderson on the back end. Isaac, the big captain, he's going to be a big, or Tanner Gold, the big captain back there, along with Olsen, they'll be factors as well. And starting in net, like we mentioned, Logan Cunningham, absolutely numbers on this world as well in the opening round series against Melville, bringing in 1.71 goals against average tonight, the save percentage of 940. So we're underway. Puck set back at the Flint Bond Bomber. That Tanchuk has got his guy tied up. Bachler in there. He stepped out there as well. And he's tied up back of the net as well. And they'll blow things down right away. So Metternak gets behind the net, does what he has to do. He holds the puck up, and now they're going to get an offensive faceoff just 22 seconds into the game.
Now, Rob, you talk about Harmon Laser-Human, how consistent he's been. And we kind of talked about it all year, about every time there's a big game and he needs to step up, he's always done so. And kind of compared to last year, just the progress he's made in general.
Justin Lees will take the faceoff against Metternak to the left of the Bomber netminder, Laser-Human. Football wins the draw. Here's Carter Anderson. Had a tough time finding his footing. Now he'll regroup. He's got it, and he'll start to skate away. Pass up the middle! Piccinino across the line, but that's whacked away. Chance right off the hot. Williams back the other way. Mentioned, of course, in our last Bomber broadcast that Riley Williams' dad, Danny, of course, a former Flint Bond Bomber, back between 97 and 99 before he finished his career with Melford. No doubt in the building tonight. Here's Piccinino, a long shot on target. Cunningham, he'll reach down and grab that. And boy, so many connections with all kinds of players and all kinds of representation of the SKHL. But this long-standing history of this Bomber team, Danny, a terrific player, had a great shot. And hard to believe it was that long ago.
You know, Rob, I always like to say Flint Bond is the world's largest small town. Anywhere you go, even vacation in Mexico, you'll always find someone who knows of the Bombers or is connected to them somehow.
Olofsson, Egan, and Niven out there for the face-off deep in battle for territory. Leper fanned on it. Puck is set outside the zone. And speaking of Kian Bell, he's out there. He'll try to chase it down as he goes in here on Noah Hull. Hull able to knock it away from him. And the Bombers will get the puck to Egan. It goes off his stick, intercepted, and sent back to the Bomber blue line. There's Leppard. Feeds it back here to Noah Hull. Noah Hull up the boards. Niven will chip it in deep. It'll roll inside the North Star zone. Back there to get it was Carvin. Can't clear it. Flintbond holds it in. Kian Bell had Niven on him, but he got rid of it. Noah Hull will pitch in. Knocked it down. Kept it inside the Battleford zone. Here's Hull along the boards. Taken away from him, but Stars can't clear. Niven in the corner. Deep in Battleford territory. To Carroll back of the net. Puck is knocked away. North Stars will carry it. Here comes Sinclair. Up the right side for Blake. It rolls past him on goal. Grabbed and covered here by Harmon Laser-Hume. A minute 45 gone and a jam-packed Whitney Forum.
Nothing too much going on right now here for either team, but Bombers getting some good possession time in the offensive zone. Only one shot so far, but, you know, getting some pressure right now on this Battleford team.
Faceoff back inside the football zone to the left of Harmon Laser-Hume. As the Stars, Ferguson lines up, but wins the draw. They're quickly away. Joey Lee's up the right side. He'll put the puck in on goal. Bouncing puck and handled no problem. And smothered here by Logan Cunningham. And we just got word the guy in the jumbotron was actually Colin Palmer, the president of the SCSA. I know he looked important. I just didn't know who I just couldn't make out who it was.
Well, if you're doing a great video like that, you got to be important to some degree.
Faceoff back in battle for territory. This time it's Gilbert lining up for the faceoff against Ferguson. Ferguson really good against the Bombers those 2 games here back in February. They'll get ahead to Jordan Drill, the big veteran forward for the Stars, throws it in. Knocked away here by Yakubchuk, his first ever SKHL playoff game tonight. Puck set back to blue line, that's knocked down, held in our second playoff game. He did get one game against Kittersey in the opening round as well. Puck fired around the boards. Joey Lees will flip it ahead. Puck bounces to center, picked up this time by Grill. Grill gets it back to Waldy. Waldy, a chance, walks in, there's a chance, and Laser Hughes is saved as he takes that one away from the North Stars, Bergeson, who was left alone in front of the net. This is a series, Austin, you cannot afford to make mistakes. You might get away with it against Kindersley, who don't have a big offensive attack. You make those mistakes in this series, it's in the back of your net. Quinn gets it back in deep. Semp working hard back of the goal. He's pinned up. Puck is picked up here by Olsen. Olsen has some room. He'll get up the left side. Picked up here quickly by Getzlaff. He'll fire it on target. Save made. And a big one by Laser Hume here early on Bergeson.
Absolutely. A huge chance by Waldy. And Harvin Laser Hume on the rebound kind of gets really out of position, almost on his back. But the Bomber D-man able to knock it out of there. But like you said, Bomber's got to be real careful here with the mistakes, because what do you, guys like Kean Bell, well, he'll find the openings, he'll find where you're lacking, and he'll put the puck in the back of the net.
17:07 to go, opening current, still no score. The shot's dead even at 2 on the Trad Realty shot clock as Justin Lees leaves in against Ben Portner. He'll be a factor in this series too, no doubt. Bombers win the draw. Here comes Anthony Piccinino. He'll fly outside the zone to center. Piccinino down the left side. They're offside. I think Carter Anderson in the far right, a little bit extra anxious as they'll hold that down. And look at that 50-50. We're already sitting at over $10,000. The game's not even 4 minutes old yet.
Yeah, I got to give credit to Tanya Benoit. She did a great job with the 50-50. It was at $7,000 when we got here at 5:30. Absolutely unbelievable.
Ben Porter against Justin Lees, faced off outside the battle for blue line. Just underway, game one of this SJHL semifinal. Once again, these two clubs in the final four. Here's a steal in front, but picking it or Lees or to Anderson, and a shot, and he gets robbed here by Cunningham. The Bombers with a rare steal. Back to back, they walk out, he scores! Low six side! And the Bombers strike only, 3:15 in, Anthony Bax, the former Dolphin King! I got so excited, I thought Lees had the first chance at Anderson, but at Bax finishes, what a start here, Austin!
What a great chance, too, you know what, right off the draw, they get the pressure, rebound comes out, Anderson brings it back out, sends it back up the back. He sees the lane right at the right circle. And with that beautiful wrist shot, Anthony Bax just fires her home for the Bombers.
Back second of the playoffs at Flint One after Harvin Laser, who makes an incredible save on Bergeson in the opening minutes. The Bombers come back and take a 1-0 lead here to get this big crowd fired up. Stars right back in. And it's on the Bombers zone. There's an open net there. They can't put it home. Here comes Sepp back to center. He'll dump it in. Cunningham will redirect it to the corner. Puck picked up back of the battle for net here by Carmen. He'll get it outside the zone. Knocked down by Boldy. Fired it right back in. There's the big D-man, Isaac. Isaac back of his net being watched here by Sim. Bombers on their fifth shot of the game. Able to beat Cunningham. Anderson will kick it up across the Bomber line. Knocked away here by Lepper. Beats it back to the hole. Here's the quick pass to Olsen. Give it go to Egan across the line. Egan hangs on his shot. Blocked by Isaac. Olsen looking for the loose puck back of the net. Chipped away from him. Here's Rask. Up the board. Just gets it out. Lepper will get a hold of it. And he'll flip it right back in. Isaac goes after. Here comes Egan barreling in on him. Egan had the series clutch. And when he goes, gets a chance in front this time to him. And he can't pull the trigger. Metternach pinned up in the corner. Egan, a nice body check there. Lepper holds it in left point. Let's a rip deflector just wide that time by Olsen. Egan. House on fire here early. Another big check as the puck is left at the center. Lepper will get it in. Stars intercept, pass up the middle. Here's a chance for Williams down the wing. He ran out of room, but he'll get some support. Williams spins and fires. First shot blocked. Williams gets it again. Williams, a backhand pass out front. Intercepted here by Joey Lees. He'll take off. Lees at center, bounces it in for Dawson Carroll. Carroll there, throws it out by Gruner, a chance! Off the side of the net, there's all kinds of traffic in front. Gruner looking to dig it free again. He's pinned up along the board, but here comes Joey Lees, a chance! Can't jam it in! Good save there by Cunningham. Some good pressure here by Flint One. Jakob just can't hold it. Loses the handle, stolen here by Sinclair. Sinclair by himself, finally loses the handle. Here's McDutt. He'll bring it back up the ice to center. He'll flip it in. Grabbed here by Olsen. Back of the battle for net. 14 and a half to go. A tremendous pace here in the opening period. Puck redirected back inside the Flint One zone. It'll roll in. There's McDutt. Banned on it. Look out. Stolen back of the goal. There's a chance here for the North Stars. Anderson. We got Anderson on both teams here. Couldn't do much with it. Flint One can't clear. Good work by Grill to hold it at the blue line. Flint One does get it free. Carter Anderson for Flint One trying to flip it ahead. That's grabbed here by Piccinino. He'll send it in. Tanner Gold back with Anderson on top of him around the boards. Gets trouble in the corner. Justin Lee's picked to try to come back out front. Gold drilled here by Anderson. Fans cheer. Puck in the corner. Lee's the captain. He'll flip it around the boards to the right side. Barreling in his back, who's got the goal. He can't hold it in. Carter Anderson forced back to his blue line. Nice pass to Justin Lee's to center. Here comes the Bomber captain. He'll take off a backhander off the glass, and he'll race after it inside the Battleford zone. Left point for Danger. Got target. Kicked away that time. Cunningham, big rebound. Stars get it back to Blake. He'll chip it ahead, but Vaughn gets it back. Here's Semp with the steal. Taken away, though. Nice defensive play that time by Porter. Porter to Bell. Key and Bell down the wing. A shot. Stopped here by Laser Hume. Bell gets his own rebound. Throws it right back out front. It's laying at the side of the net. And Noah Hull will grab it. Hull will stay within the center. Three Bombers away. Here's Noah Hull. Drop pass. Semp, a shot. And a stick save made by Cunningham. And great end-to-end action, Austin Mattis. What a start to game number one.
What a pace from both teams right now. And the pressure from the Bombers is relentless, giving the Battleford North Stars no time to breathe in their own end. Credit to the North Stars, though, getting a few opportunities to score, really looking for that cross-freeze pass, but Bombers doing a great job of clogging up the lane and really putting on the pressure here in the offensive zone.
Based off inside the North Stars zone, Semple lined up here against Metternak, who's looked good for the Stars here so far. Battleford wins the faceoff. Here's Williams. Here's a good pass up the middle, but Bondo able to clear it out. Picked up there by Metternak. He'll flip it back in. They're offside, blown down with 7 minutes gone here. Official on the goal, Anthony Bax, a second of the playoffs, Carter Anderson, and Anthony Piccinino, they got the assist, and boy, got the crowd really going here early. There's got to be, what, 1,400 people here tonight?
It's a packed house, Rob, you know what, and this is what the fans in Flin Flon want Thursday night, nowhere else they'd rather be.
Like we said, no better place in junior A hockey for a playoff atmosphere than the Whitney Forum. Here's Isaac, the big D-man for the Stars, ahead to Williams. Williams chipped it ahead, but it's taken away, and there's Bachler for Flin Flon. Feeds it back to Gilbert. Gilbert's got it at center. He'll stick handle inside the North Stars zone. Nice pass out front! Ooh, redirected just wide that time by Semp. Didn't get a lot of wood on it, but might have had the goaltender Cunningham fool. Buck back of the battle for net. They'll dig it free. Williams' pass. Set to Metternak at the right side, inside Flin Flon territory. Metternak stop! Throws it out front. He had a guy there. Carbon couldn't pick it up. Here comes Olsson outside the zone. Needs it back to Leper. He'll flip it in. Olsson after it. Knocked it down the corner. Back up front. He get a chance. He fires it on target. Good save, Cunningham, with a lot of traffic in front. That's a tough save to make.
Right now, the Bombers doing a great job on the breakout. The second they get the puck in their own end, they're flying down the lanes, making great passes. And basically every breakout or rush they've had, they're getting a high-quality shot. And they just got to keep on pouncing here on this Battleford team.
Almost going to take the face off against Penn Porter right back in Battleford territory. The Stars with the draw again. Fired down the boards that time, or down the ice that time by Grill. Yakimchuk will give way. And there is, I don't know if I can really see a lot of empty seats in the building here tonight. Standing room, they're all over the place. And you're right. Obviously a lot of excitement. Both teams sweeping their opening round playoff series. This is sixth meeting since 2016. And the first meeting since last year's final. So fans jacked up, no doubt, all over the place. Olsson will line up again against Porter. But Bond wins this one. Yakimchuk shot, knocked down in front, never makes it through. Cleared back to center. McNutt back on top of it, he'll hammer it in. That's picked up back of the goal this time by Granger. Off the boards, played to center, grabbed by Yakimchuk, he'll send it in. Granger will grab it. He'll take a look. Hangs onto it, now he sends the pass back. That's grabbed here by Grill. Grill. Flipped it back to Granger. Granger over to Bell. He'll chip it in. Puck will roll back to the Bomber net. There's McNutt after it, and he'll clear it out. Grill has it at center. Grill spins, fires it right back in. Laser Hume will stop that back of the net. That's where it's picked up this time by McNutt. 11 and a half to go in the opening period. Shots are 9-3 Bombers on the Tribe Realty shot clock, and they lead it 1-0 on a goal by Baxter. Here's Key and Bell. Bell, little shake and bake across the line. A backhander. Just flipped it over top of the net. Joey Lees has got a break. One guy to beat. It's Olsson. Lees a shot. Safe rebound. He fired over top of the net. I can't give it out front, and he couldn't capitalize. Yakimchuk back to center. Boy, he kicked that rebound right out to him. Stolen again by Lees. A shot, and he ripped it wide that glove side. Some good chances for him. Gets left. Sends it back in the Flin Flon zone. Vax is there. Played it ahead. Kicked away across the Battleford line by Gilbert. And Gold, the captain, has it. gets that one back to Rask. He'll flip it inside the foot Quan zone. Backs back to get it. Up the boards. Carroll gets a hold of it. Sends it across to Piccinino. Back across the line. Going wide here on Isaac. Piccinino looking for some room. The big D-man will toss him to the ice. And our stars will skate up the ice. Here comes Carmen, the center, down the wing. Inside flip quad territory, lifted it in. There's Tanchuk back of his net for Justin Lees around the board for Anderson. A backhand pass, a good one to Bats. Here comes Piccinino. Across the line. Ripped it over top of the battle for net. Lees the other side on target. Stick save B. Cunningham. Puck back of the goal. Piccinino tried to flip it up front. Isaac knocked it down. Piccinino got it back. Piccinino trying to get away here from Carmen. Lepper at the blue line. Lepper a good move. Walks in. Shoots. Oh, big save. Cunningham rebound. They can't jam it in. A good stop there by Cunningham. Keeping the door closed. Anderson back to Lees. Inside the North Star zone. Flint Flon is buzzing. 1-0 lead here. Looking for more. Anderson. He'll pick it up. Along the boards. Lepper through traffic. Cunningham again. And Justin Lees out front looking for some room. He and the big one of the big battle for D-man there mixing it up. But boy, I'll tell you what, some big saves here by Cunningham. Gives up an early goal, but some pretty good saves. Media timeout already. That's how good the action. Good, we'll take a break. Bombers in front, 1-0 here on 1029 CFARM, footballonline.com.
Take the wheel.
Clear.
Steer your future towards success. University College of the North is offering Class 5 adult driver training. You'll get a 16-hour course, 4 1-hour in-car sessions, and testing support. Email class5driver at ucn.ca for more info. UCN, here you can.
Ayugay to tanao. University College of the North, sa kinutigis kinomagay nao, ay ikanto pa atin nao, ucn.ca, UCN, ay kutagis panyo.
Thank you for choosing Lily of Triad Realty to be your real estate agent. Your confidence in inviting Lily on your journey, whether buying or selling, means the world to her. Because of your love of Flin Flon and you wanting to be a part of this community, Lily has been awarded the Silver Individual MLS Medallion Award for 2 years running. Flin Flon has sold a record number of homes.
10 seconds.
So privileged to be part of a group that loves to call Flin Flon home. Lily says, thank you for trusting me and for being part of making Flin Flon such a great place to call home.
You're on.
And welcome back to Whitney Form. Already a half a period gone. Outstanding pandemonium here from the fans and a great play on the ice for these longtime SKHL rivals. Wow. What a start to the SKHL semifinal. Here's Delahoole to the front and he shoots it. That one got blocked, never made it through. The puck is sent back down the ice and Lepper will pick it up in his own zone. And be careful, that's Sinclair on him. Back to Hull, who really looks jacked up tonight. Hull to center. Lost the handle, lifted back outside the zone. Bakker comes back to get it at center. Remember, no Alexi Silvestri tonight, so Bombers trying to go at it with one of their hottest forwards. Not only was he really big in the opening round playoff series, but really carried the mail for them down the stretch in the regular season, the last 10 games or so. Here's Grill, back to Metternach. Across the line, a shot kicked away by Laserhill. Rebound picked up by Sinclair. Hull there, though. Got it in the corner, feeds it up to Lepper. Sinclair takes it, but it's redirected by Walker back to center. Grill will get a hold of it. He'll hammer it right back in. There's Lepper. Lays it back in the zone. Noah Hull still out there for Flin Flon. Long shift for him. Had to be careful. Had Bell all over him. Just got rid of it. Here's Niven. Up the right side. Olsson knocked it down. Olsson cut again. Shoots it. Save made. Rebound. They can't get to it. But another outstanding save here by Cunningham. It's been a good opening period for him. He needed to be good, and he has been. Stars will get it back to center. Picked up by Tanchuk. He'll rifle it in. 8:18 to go. 14-4. The Triad Realty shot clock. And again, Flin Flon in front. 1-0 on a big goal here by Anthony Bax. Here's Egan. Keeps it in deep, but knocked away by Gold. Gold will play it up the right side. Tanchuk there to get it. Tanchuk off the boards. Back to Olsson. He's got to lay it again. Walked in a shot. Big left pad save. Rebound Lees. He's been flying here in the opening period. Tanchuk on target. Glove save made. How about the play of Joey Lees in this opening period?
I was going to say, Rob, not only this opening period, but you know what? In the past series and the last part of the season, really been doing a great job of finding the opening and finding his job on the ice, getting on some great shots, but also Logan Cunningham. We talked about how good he was in that first series against Melville. Doing a great job right now, making some huge saves for Battleford.
Ferguson has had the best chance for Battleford tonight. We'll take the faceoff here against the Bombers, Gruner. Deep in Battleford territory. Stars with the draw. This is Isaac, the big D-man. Isaac, so tough to play against, gets it ahead, picked up at center ice. Here comes Bergeson across the line. A shot scores! Bergeson! Fooling Harmon Laser Humes over top of his left shoulder. We got a tie game at one, and that's why you always shoot the puck.
And wow, just like that, you know what? Quick little rush there.
Good against Flint Flon.
A very surprising shot. I don't think Harmon Laser Hume was expecting that one and just got the glove up a second too late. And a nice little shot hits the back of the net, all tied up 1-1, and battle for a dancer's back just like that.
Yes, Bergeson, that's his third of the playoffs. And like I said, has played very good against Flint Flon so far this year. That might be an unassist. Well, somebody had to feed it to him, so there should be an assist on it. But the Stars have tied it. Bergeson just inside the line. Third of the playoffs. Isaac, the big deep man, he's the guy that got it to him. So there you have it, 1-1, and again, that's why you shoot the puck, and you're right, he wasn't expecting it, but that's why you shoot it, because you always hope to catch a goalie off guard, right?
Absolutely. You know, they only have five shots right now, Triad Realty shot clock for the battle for his North Stars. But as we always like to say, Rob, it doesn't matter how many shots you take, it matters the type of shots they are, and that was a great one.
Well, he got robbed earlier, so I guess that's poetic justice for him.
I guess so, yeah.
Laser Hill absolutely robbed him in the first couple of minutes of the game, but he comes back. Big Bergeson to tie things up. It's 1-1. Just a fifth shot of the game for the Stars, but it's a big, big goal as Flint Flon had all kinds of momentum. Well, it's quieted the crowd down too, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Isaac will feed this one back here to Carmen at center. He'll find Blake. Blake, a good move across the line. Lost the handle, though. McNutt up the boards. Anderson can't get to it, but Lees can. Lees will get a hold of it. Took a funny hop off the partition, but gets it deep. Pichinino's been a firecracker for the Bombers early tonight for Lees. Lees has it. Down low, Anderson! Oh, he ripped it over top of the net! He looked like he was looking for that top blocker side. What a pass by Lees! But Anderson, a little bit too high over the net.
Yeah, great pass by Lees, though. Rob lets the defenseman lay down, is patient enough, waits for the puck to get past, hooks it right in front. Great pass, and Carter Anderson just a little too excited. But some great pressure yet again from the Bombers here.
The fans in disbelief. They can't believe he didn't score. Lees will take the faceoff here against Betternack to the left of David Cunningham. What an opening, or Logan Cunningham, rather, what a period he's having after giving up that early goal. David Cunningham, of course, the goalie for Nipawin. Here's Pichinino. Going to come back to left where that's knocked away by Williams. Poked away, but Grill will grab it. He's across the Bomber line. Grill hangs on. Stick fires. That one didn't miss by much. Had a lot on it. On Battleford, I'm shooting from everywhere because you just never know. Anderson, who missed moments ago, has it along the boards. To Lees, he can't knock it down. Betternack batting on it. Flint Flon, though, able to get it. Noah Hull to center. Noah Hull after it. He'll poke it back in, and Anderson will race after with Sempa patrolling out front. Sempa actually gets to him. Made a good move to come over and take that puck away, but then he lost it. Puck lifted off the glass back in the Flint Flon zone. And here's a quick pass to Walker. Full sail change for Battleford. Jacob Walker dancing across the Battleford line. Walker will bring it in. Back to the goal that goes. Picked up this time by Semp. Cohen Semp. Left it in the corner. Walker trying to get away. Take it to the ice here. Dan's looking for a call. Williams will take off the other direction. The terrific rookie Rylan Williams listed over top of the Bomber net. Semp can't knock it down. Stolen this time by Bergeson, who was looking for his second of the game. Fanned on it. Flint Flon got it out. Gilbert chipped it back down the ice. We're down to 5:40 to go. Opening period, a 1-1 game. Big hit there! Walker comes over and steamrolls past. Puck lifted back down the ice, and here comes the goal scorer for Flint Flon. Icing against. Oh, we got a penalty here, Austin. I think we do anyway.
That's not going to be on Walker, is it?
No, maybe. I know what he's signaling, but he can't make a change here. He's got his five fingers up.
Okay, I was going to say, that was a great hit by Blockler there.
That's kind of one big time the referee puts his hands up. But no, he wanted to make sure they didn't try and make changes here on the icing call, I believe. I thought the linesman looked at that, but the referee went over there and was the one that kind of made sure that Battleford had to put everybody back on the ice. Olsen against Bergeson, faced off deep in Stars territory. Battleford, though, quickly. That's Anderson for the North Stars. We'll throw it back in Flint Flon territory with McNutt waiting for it. Good job to play it ahead to Egan. Oh, what a pass to Niven. Rick wide. Niven will take off across the line. Walks in a shot. And here's Cunningham. You can tell that he's dialed in because look at his positioning. Top of the blue paint. No rebounds at all. He's dialed in. He knows exactly where the net is. Cutting down the angles. Outstanding period of hockey for him.
But it just shows the confidence, right? When you're coming that far out of the net, it just shows you're confident, you're ready for that, you're not scared, and you're really trying to make that angle as hard as you can for that shooter.
Lees against Anderson, face off back in North Star territory again. Most of the play's been in the Battleford zone, but it's only a 1-1 game. Again, the Trad Realty shot clock, 17-5 point butters. Another shot on target, glove save made by Cunningham, and they'll quickly get rid of the puck. Rask to center, nice passes. He'll get Getzlaff. He kind of bobbled it a little bit, but it was a nice setup. Flip-flop throws it right back in front of their own net. Lees there to grab it. That was dangerous. Lees forced in the corner, up the boards, picked up here by Carter Anderson. Carter Anderson lifted ahead for Piccinino, broken up here by Carmen. Can't get up, big body check there. Anderson steps in the corner. He'll drill him just below us. And by Flip-flop, by far the more physical team here tonight. Austin Matt is making note of those body checks, of course, for our post-game show award tonight. The shockwave of the game, you've got a lot of good material to work with.
Oh, there's been some good ones, Rob.
Puck leg back inside the Flint-Flon zone. It's underneath a whole pile of players. Dug free here by Porter, who took the big hit. He's down back of the goal. Justin Lees will rip it around the boards. Picked up here by Egan. Can't clear. Held in this time by Grill. Back of the goal. Lees has got it. Justin Lees for Flint-Flon. Ahead to Carter Anderson. And they'll flip it off the glass back in battle for territory. There goes Granger there to get it. Granger beats that one back over to Blake. Lost the handle, living at center. We'll tap it ahead for Olsson. Olsson's had a nice game again here tonight. Trying to come back to Egan off the tip of the stick and a roll back in deep. Racing after it that time was Granger. Beats it back to center. Olsson can't knock it down. Here's Key and Bell. Bell across the line. Shot off blocked by Kanchuk. Bell gets his own rebound, shovels it in deep. Noah Hull, back of his own net. Good forecheck here by the North Stars. Bell's got it pinned up with Kanchuk on top of him. Behind the Bomber net, 3.5 to play in the period. Good job by Bell to hold it up for a faceoff.
And Rob, you mentioned kind of about how a lot of the possession right now has been in favor of the Bombers, but that's one thing this Battlefront team is really good at. You know what? They don't need a lot of shots. They don't need a lot of possession, but they'll get you on the mistakes. They're very good at taking advantage. They'll wait for that one mistake. And if you go back to that game three against Melville, they're down 3-0. Melville probably thinks they have it in the bag. And then four unanswered goals just from silly mistakes in the third period. And that's what this Battleford team lives off of.
Well, you're right. They are a tough out. And they come back. And that was kind of the secret, you know, that for the great years they had last year, they came back from deficits all the time.
Oh, exactly. You know what?
Look at Flint-Flon last year, those two games to North Battleford back in November. They had leads in both those games with less than 5 minutes left and lost both of them.
They're a very sneaky team and know how to take advantage.
You're right, they'll be tough, but they've had a tough first period here tonight, but they're still right in this game at 1-1 and starting to get their legs going. Bergeson knocked that one down. A goal for him already tonight. Walker will push it back to center. That's picked up by Gold. He'll lift it off the glass back to the Flint-Flon zone. Anthony Max lost the handle. They throw it on target. Big rebound in front. The Stars get close again. Just fired wide that time by Ethan Anderson. And the puck is sent over the glass out of play with just under 3 minutes to go. Battleford slowly starting to get back into it.
Yeah, I think they're kind of, you know what, after having basically a full week off, same as the Bombers, right, you always kind of wonder if teams are going to come out slow, how that 4 weeks is week affected them. I think maybe Battleford's in that first 10, 15 minutes, a little slow in the legs after not being on the ice, but they're definitely picking up the pace now.
Face off again to the right of Harmon Lees, who knew this. Justin Lees will line up for the face off against Ben Porter. 2:58 remaining. Capacity crowd here tonight. That's the way it should be in the playoffs. The Bombers running around the board. Harmon waits for it. The Battleford star inside of center. Beats that one back up to Isaac. He'll put them right back in. There's McNutt. Played it ahead. Grabbed here by Anderson. Anderson will take off for the Bombers to center. Here he comes. Anderson feeds it out front. Piccinino couldn't pick it up cleanly. He'll get a hold of it. Back of the goal. Grabbed in the corner here by Lees. Justin Lees trying to get away from Isaac. Piccinino will get a hold of it. He comes back out front. McNutt from the blue line. Shot back down. Spinning it. Firing it. Piccinino can't put it in. I think Cunningham got his pad on it. Here's Lees. Left point for Leper again. Through traffic. Piccinino tried to knock it down. Grabbed in the corner this time by Porter. Back of the goal. They'll send it out front. Knocked down by Hull. He'll hold it in. Bell got a piece but couldn't knock it out. Bombers trying to hold it in. Anderson can't get to it. Isaac, a nice job to tie him up. He'll get it back to Anderson again. Had to wait for Lees to get outside. He does. Anderson back out front. Key and Bell. He'll intercept it. He'll take off. Here comes Bell. Down the right side. Bell trying to go forehand to backhand, but the D-man made a good play on it. Bombers get it back to Leper. Leper feeds it back to Hull. Hull back across the Battleford line. Lots of guys coming in front of the net. Look out! All kinds of chaos in front of those two benches. On the basic, nobody got a too many men on the ice call there. Metternach is taken down with all. Talking about a malfunction conjunction with two line changes going at exactly the same time.
Yeah, definitely could have been some bad news for either team. Luckily for both teams, nothing happens there, but now finally some pressure here from Battleford North Stars. But Anthony Piccinino, he seems to be in all the right places tonight. I think you've probably said his name at least 20 times so far, Rob, but he is running the lanes and doing a great job getting the puck right on his stick and finding those lanes for the good opportunities.
All of a sudden against Metternach outside the bomber line. Stars win the draw. They'll fire it right back in. There's Lee's Doom back to his net. In the corner here, picked up by Niven. He'll bounce that off the boards. Grill couldn't knock it down. Olesik. Colin Olesik will get it. He's taken down hard. He's going to draw the first penalty of the hockey game. Quickbot throws it on target. Cunningham will pick it up. Here's Kanchuk. Hopefully Olesik's okay. He must be. He's right back up. He got grilled. Back to blue line. Gets away from Lees. The net is empty. It'll roll down the ice, and it looks like Sinclair's going to go back and touch it. No, he missed it. I didn't even hear a whistle out there.
I didn't hear a whistle either. I'm so confused. I thought that was
so
loud, but...
Anyway, a penalty being handed out here to Jordan Grill. The Bombers will get a chance here with just 59 seconds left in the period to try and get a power play goal.
And this is huge for the Bombers. At the end of the period, goals at the end of the period or goals at the beginning of the period, that's where the game is made. So a huge opportunity for this number one power play during the regular season of the Flint Flon Bombers.
Well, the power play managed to score five times with 17 man advantages in the opening round against Kindersley. Estevan, the only team in the playoffs with a better power play ratio than Flint Flon. Bombers 29.4% coming in tonight. The battle for penalty kill, pretty darn good. They've only given up two goals on the power play. 89.5% so far in the playoffs. Here's Metternach, shorthanded. He'll send in. He's going to force Laser Hume out of the net. Over to Anderson in the corner. There's 45 seconds. Go. Great penalty killing here by Metternach. Rockler. Played it ahead. Here comes Justin Lees to center. Lees will carry it across the Battleford line. Justin Lees dancing across the line. Hangs onto it. Back to Noah Hull. Hull dishes it off to Bachler. Bachler's got it. Back to Hull again. Anderson ripped it. Great glove save. Boy, not a lot of pucks are fooling Cunningham in this first period.
I was going to say, and Carter Anderson, that's his favorite spot there on the power play. Right at that
Cunningham
right circle.
Cunningham right there.
Yeah, Cunningham knew he was going to shoot, I think, even before Carter Anderson did, because he was in position, ready for that glove save like he saw it coming.
25 seconds to go in the period. Here we go again. Big face-off back in the North Star zone. First power play of the game. Great job by Williams. Boy, has he been good tonight. He fights it off and gets it down the ice. 15 seconds to go. Hull's going to have to hurry here. He'll dish it off to Bachler. He'll come right back across the zone. Intercepted. Williams, a chance for a shorthanded break with his 7 seconds. Williams cutting in. Shoots, and he just missed. Oh, what a great effort here by Rylan Williams. And Bachler will pick it up, and that'll do it for the period. Boy, was Williams, for as good as Cunningham was, Rylan Williams might be the best star on the ice in the opening period. But between those two guys.
Oh, you know what? And he had a great chance there. And I think Harmon Lester, you may have caught a break because if the Bombers didn't get
you had a beat.
Absolutely. So the Bombers didn't get their stick on that. That's a goal. But, wow, great back and forth hockey. Maybe the Bombers had a bit of the edge here. But you know what? Battleford, for only having 7 shots on goal, you would have thought it'd be a whole lot more.
So it's a 1-1 game after one. Now Bombers will have a 1-1 on the power play when we return for the second period. Let's take a break. The First Intermission Show. Let's try to catch our breath and take a break. First Intermission Show for the Co-op coming up right here on 102.9 CFAR. Rocky Farm. What an opening period here of this first game of this SJHL semifinal. 1-1 to score, and Bombers came out absolutely flying. Get a goal, 3:15 in to get the crowd into it. Anthony Bax, the former Dauphin King, of course, they picked him up. January the 10th gave up a lot to get him. And, of course, Ashton Paul, a terrific young forward from Northern Manitoba, and, of course, a player to be named later for next year. But, boy, big goal by Bax. Expect that of the veteran guys. Got the puck right off the boards there. Austin walked in, and a beautiful shot stick side. The only one to beat Cunningham in that opening period. Really closed the door after that, but let's put on the big crowd. You want to score first, and they did that.
Well, absolutely, and that was the momentum they needed. And Mike Reagan was actually on a podcast earlier this week with HN Live, and he said one of the big things he loved about Anthony Bax was his ability to rip it from the blue line and his shot. And you know what? Clear and point right there. He's been having great shots all season, and what a beauty there, just above the right circle through traffic, puts it home, and just exactly the kind of stuff you need, especially here at the Whitney Forum. You always talk about it, Rob, how important those first goals are, especially in front of a home crowd, and that's exactly what the Bombers needed.
Bax's second of the playoffs. Anderson and Piccinino, the assist at 3:15, but the Stars have come back. Maybe not a pretty goal, but they don't care. They're on the road. They're looking to steal home ice advantage. Ferguson, been a Bomber killer in the past this year. He got robbed early, but he gets another opportunity. Took the pass. Isaac, how good is I? Well, you know, talking about how great Cunningham and how good Williams are, I got to put Kudo in there for Isaac, too. He's been so tough to play against. Muscled off a couple of guys. Austin gets the goal up the ice. Ferguson picks it up. He gets across the blue line, and I don't know if he's thinking about scoring. I think he's probably thinking, I just want to hit the net here, make something happen. Able to fool Laser him over his left shoulder, and we got a tie hockey game.
Well, that's one of the things with this battle for team. You know what? Obviously, they got Keane Bell, they got Ben Borner, but you know what? Didn't hear too much from them in that first period. Touched the puck a few times, but they have tons of other guys. In case in point, there with Bergeson. Great shot, catches Harmon Laser Hume off guard, and then, like you said, Isaac. You know what? Maybe not always be scoring goals, but setting guys up with the big body, he's able to.
I think he's the toughest defenseman to play against in the league.
Oh, definitely one of them. You know what? He's a big body. He's great vision, and he's able to shrug off hits. He has a great vision, great smooth passing right there, basically a tape-to-tape pass, and a very unsuspecting shot on Armin Laser Hume from Bergeson, but Bergeson, yeah, puts it right in the right place, catches Laser Hume off guard, and then we got a 1-1 game.
And it's simple, but again, it just goes to show you why it's so important to always shoot the puck. So Bax opens it up, his second, Bergeson answers with his third. That's the story after one of the shots, all flip one, 20-7, and I'll tell you what, out of those 20 shots, there weren't a lot of freebies. A lot of them were in tight. That's how good Cunningham was.
Oh, I think out of those 20 shots, you know what? You put some other goalies in there, I think the Bombers are scoring about three or four goals off him. There were some unbelievable saves and some rebounds he let loose. But even on the rebounds he let loose, he was still back in position there to cover it. So Logan Cunningham really been a great player right now for this Battle for its team. Can he keep it up? That's going to be the question everyone's wanting to know. But you know what? If he plays like this the entire game, I think the North Stars are in good hands.
And let's face it, Battleford's only going to get better as the night goes on too, right?
No, absolutely. You know what? Like we said, they had the 1 week off. Obviously, when you get back on the ice, especially here at the Whitney Forum, there may be a little bit of nerves. Maybe, you know, need to get back into the rhythm of things. Battleford's definitely back in their rhythm now, and they're only going to keep getting better as the game goes on.
Shots, like we said, 20-7 in favor of Flint-Bond. Not a lot of penalties. Just a one minor penalty called against the Stars at the end of the period. The Bombers will carry over the final minute one into the second, so we'll take another break. Matt Egan is our Northland Court Flint-Bond Bomber player profile. Scored the series-clinching winning goal against the Kenosha Clippers here last week, which now seems like that was an eternity ago. But anyway, a great series. Great to have Matt back. He'll join us momentarily. Of course, his third tour of duty in the playoffs. He was with him in the Centennial Cup run. He was with him in the final run last year. He'll be a very important cog down, and he showed that in this opening period. Big hits of House of Fire. Always great to catch up with Matt. He joins us next. More of the opening intermission straight ahead on 102.9 CFERN, FlintBondOnline.com.
Claire, brutal hit into the boards. That sends four through the ring.
They'll need to be sent for shockwave therapy. A full-range therapy in Croydon for sure.
Pain reduction, restoration of movement. That's just what's needed here.
With stem cell activation, accelerating the healing of bone, muscles, and tendons.
Better call or go online for an appointment because shockwave is ideal for everyone who battles everyday and injury pain.
Win the pain game against chronic headaches, injuries, arthritis, neck, back pain, and more. Book a shockwave appointment with Mark at FullRangeTherapy.com. Your transformation awaits.
North Platform proudly supports the Flint Flon Bombers in the SJHL playoffs, and we know they'll play tough like the Ford F-150, the toughest truck on the market for over 45 years and counting. Northland Ford is helping the community cheer on the Bombers as they fight.
10 seconds.
Trip back home where it belongs. That will provide you with the best selection to choose from in the North for the North. Northland Ford, the dealership you tell your friends about.
You're on.
Welcome to our first intermission. Our Northland Ford football Bomber player profile, Matt Egan, joins us fresh off a series-clinching winning goal against the Kennesaw Clippers last week. Is that the biggest goal for you in your Bomber career so far there, Matt?
It's got to be one of them for sure, you know. Good chip play by Gruder there to, you know, give it to me in the middle, and, you know, I'm not afraid to use my shot, so I use it, and, you know, went in and won the game, so I'm happy.
Did you see an opening when you shot that puck? Because it looked like it was perfectly placed to me.
Yeah, I saw something a little bit. I kind of had my head up, and then, to be honest, I kind of just had my head down and ripped that puck and went in, so, yeah.
And it was a big one because, yeah, it was a big goal at that time. It was 1-0. Of course, that made it 2, and we all know they scored late, so. Not only a big goal, but a big goal for the team. And, you know, it's a pretty special memory. I mean, Kindersley, you never know. I mean, you give them some momentum, they come back, and anything can happen. So that's a big thing. You got to keep your foot on the gas pedal. Your team did that. That was last series. This is this one. And I think everybody knew you'd be beating the Battle for Stars at one point. Your thoughts, Matt, on heading into game one here in the SJHL semifinal?
Yeah, definitely very excited. The whole group is very excited. We know Battle for Stars is a strong team. They also swept Melville in last round, so. You know, it's gonna be a battle, and we're ready for it. We had a good week of practice, so we're all ready.
It's probably what, the third time you faced them in your playoff career?
Yeah, this will be the third time.
Of course, it was the league final this past spring. Is that still fresh in a lot of guys' minds, Matt, or was that then and this is now?
I'd say so. Yeah. You know, try not to think about the past too much, but you know, there's that sour taste still, and you know, it's gonna. You know, it's going to be an emotional series. We're all excited, like I said, and, you know, we're wanting revenge on Battleford.
It must feel good to be starting at home, too, right?
Definitely, yeah, huge advantage.
I mean, this team's played well on the road, too, but especially with momentum coming out of the last series with a bit of a break, it's nice to be in your own bed and kind of do your own routines, right?
For sure, yeah, I know. You know, Rags always preaches about, you know, if we can get the sweep because, you know, the rest is huge. You know, you look at our team last year and even the year before, we battled through a lot of injuries, and you know, this year we wanted to make a difference. So yeah, that the rest was huge.
Well, like we said, we'll see what happens here tonight. First, Ted, we know the crowd's going to be just absolutely electric. What's it like? I mean, you've gone through this lots now. You come out here, the place is absolutely. Everybody's got, of course, their Bomber stuff on, whether it's hats, whether it's jerseys, jackets, faces painted, drums, sirens, horns, all over the place. Can you describe what type of a feeling that is?
Yeah, it's pretty special feeling, you know. Not a lot of players get to experience that. You know, it's definitely a privilege to be a Bomber, and you know, I've been super thankful to be here for 3 years now, and you know, this being my last year, and you know, I'm sure for the other guys who are moving on next year, you know, this is a very special moment, and we love our fans and we love this team, so yeah.
And of course, you get the send-offs every time you hit that, you know. We talk about the way before, but you get a lot of good fan exposure on the road as well. These fans travel well.
For sure, yeah. You know, just going back to those special things, all the little things they do that, you know, make us feel welcomed, and, you know, yeah, it's great.
Listen, Matt, I know you've gone through a lot of adversity the last few years, in particular this year. How do you feel? And I imagine you must be just absolutely thrilled that you're able to play here tonight in such a big, big game for this team.
Yeah, for sure. You know, just, you know, I had to flip the page on those hard times, and you know, I'm not looking back on it. You know, I feel great, I feel healthy, I'm happy I get to be playing now, super thankful, and you know, going back to the support's been great, and you know, we got a great group of guys, and yeah.
You went to the Centennial Cup a couple years back, you went to the finals again last year. What have the playoff memories meant to you, and what did you learn from playing with so many great players here the last couple of years?
There's a lot of things, and you know, I think the one big thing is coming together as a team, and you know, you learn a lot. For me, I've learned a lot being in Flint Flon, just you know, the whole team environment, and you know, I use some of that stuff outside of hockey, you know, whatever it is, whether it's with work or whatever. But I'd say that.
And like we said, such great leadership. I remember Smith a couple of years ago one of the best leaders I've ever seen in hockey. What was it like to play with him?
Unreal. That's probably the best word I can explain it. And, you know, I still look up to him to this day. You know, he's probably one of the best captains I've been with. He was always there for me when I needed. And, yeah, overall, a great person off the ice, great player on the ice. So, loved him.
This organization's had so many great guys throughout the years. Quickly, Battleford, the defending league champions. Key and Bell, obviously, we know how good he is. I know you're going to want to key on him, but you got to be careful, too, because you key on him, and they got other guys that can hurt you as well. What will be the key, do you think, for your team to beat them this time?
Yeah, just going back to, you know, team effort, playing as a team, and, you know, playing Bomber hockey. You know, I've said a lot before, you know, playing fast, physical, and hard to play against, and, you know, trusting the coaching staff of what kind of systems we got to run against them, and pay attention to the little details, and, you know, once if we do that, we're going to be successful.
And I'm assuming doing what you do best, crashing and hitting, right?
Yeah, you know it.
That'll be a big, big part. Quickly, Matt, before I let you go, biggest moment for you in your hockey career anywhere, what would it be? What comes to mind?
That one's tough. I'd probably have to say the first year. I've said it before, just, you know, unfortunately, we didn't win the finals in our first year, and you know, just the experience of going all the way and getting that Centennial Cup experience, you know, that's been a big part of my experience here, and yeah, I'd have to go with that.
I know I talked about the series, plenty of goal amongst the highlights. Another personal highlight for you in a Bomber uniform. What would come to mind?
I think just coming back after my diagnosis for sure. You know, like I said before, it's super tough and unfortunate, but you know, I was able to get back and come back healthy and stronger and faster and, you know, provide the team what I do best, so I'd have to go with that.
And you look fantastic. I mean, you look like, I mean, that's one thing to keep yourself in shape the way you did. I mean, you look as good as you ever did, and it's great to have you back in a Bomber uniform, Matt. I know the Bombers love having you. The community, the league, great to have you here. Good luck in this big game one here in this big series tonight.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Always been there for
Clara.
Gave me comfort when I was sad.
Supported me when I needed it. But now I just can't stand to see you like this. Ripped up, stained, thinking, I love you, but it's time to let you go.
Sweetie, are you talking to the sofa again?
No.
We all love our furniture, but sometimes when you love something, you have to let it go. Upgrade your furniture with Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center.
McDonald's and Flin Flon wish the Flin Flon Bombers the best of luck the rest of the way now that they're in the SJHL semifinals, and are also excited to announce their cold brew lineup. Cold brew made with Arabica beans that are cold brewed to create that smooth cold coffee experience served over ice. The lineup includes the French vanilla cream cold brew, the caramel cream cold brew, sweetened cold brew with cream, that cold brew with a sugar-free syrup and cream, and the smooth vanilla soft serve with pieces of milk chocolate swirled together with a delicious flavor of a sweet Cadbury.
10 seconds.
Available now at your local McDonald's in Flin Flon. Don't forget, drive-thru open daily at 7 a.m.
You're on.
And we're just underway with puck drop to kick off the second period. The Bombers again a minute on the power play in this 1-1 game. Bex for Flin Flon, and Ferguson has come back for the Stars. The goal scorers tonight, Justin Lees will poke it in. And he gets the stick up high here. He jammed it underneath the mask of Carman. He's lucky he didn't get a penalty. The puck is lifted down the ice. And Laser Hill will make the save, and Hull will pick up the puck back of his net. He'll start to skate away. He'll swing the pass. Here's Walker in the center. Around the boards, back in battle for territory. Carter Anderson can't pick it up. Rolls back to Hull at the right point. He'll hold it in. Sends it back to Walker. Here's Noah Hull. Walks in, shot, good glove save again, Cunningham. He'll reach down and grab that one. McDonald's out of town scoreboard tonight. Of course, the Mustang Broncos, the other two teams still alive. Won't get going for another 5 minutes or so, as they won't start till 8:30 Manitoba time. Manitoba Junior Hockey playoffs set for the two semifinals will start tomorrow. More coming up on that, our next break. Gruner lines up for the faceoff. The Stars win the draw, though. That's picked up and whistled down the ice that time by Anderson of the Stars. And Bakker will pick it up. His Bomber power play looking a little bit puzzled right now, Austin Mattis.
Yeah, not as good as they want to do, for sure.
They didn't go back after that puck very hard. Here comes Sinclair the other way. Sinclair down the wing, shorthanded. Bakker poked it away from him. Penalty is now over. And the Bombers are 0-1 with the power play tonight. And great penalty killing here by the Stars to begin the second period.
Yakimchuk ties up with his guy. Grill in there as he bags away with Bruner. Gold will get to it, but taken away here by Divot. Back to five aside. Played that one back to Hull. Hull, look out! Almost lost the handle, but he got it back. Great play by him. How about the announcement for his older brother, Donovan Hull? Chance to play in the American Hockey League. He may, in fact, play in the NHL one day. He's that good. But congratulations to former Bomber alumni Donovan Hull. There's Matt Egan with a drive. Just fired it wide. Divot, or backs rather, keeps it in. Chance to put open net! Almost a chance to do a rebound. Picked up. There he is!
Talk about how much he loves this team, how much he's done for this team. It's his third year, and there he goes. What are the odds? Comes out and scores the goal for the Bombers on a nice rebound, and that's the kind of play that he likes to make.
Almost just missed. Cunningham stopped the rebound out front, and boy, Matt Egan, that's another big goal.
And that's why the fans of Flint Farm love him so much. He gets in the dirty areas, he gets in the dirty goals, and he's not afraid to lay the body and get in there where other people won't.
Matt Egan scores early in the second break. Flint Flood back in front, 2-1 here. And the Bombers come right back after the goal, and they get it in. We got a penalty coming up here. Referee's got his hand up. Olaf's got a chance. And I'm not sure what the call's going to be here, but the referee was in behind the play. You saw it down the ice. And I think it's going to go here to Niven, I believe. I think Niven caught Isaac here with a high stick. He did. Is he cut? Well, it's only 2 minutes. Isaac was trying to say he cut him for four, but Niven will take the penalty for high sticking and battle for the chance to tie the game there. Their first power play of the game.
Yeah, well, you know what? Bombers get a goal, but now Battleford has a big chance to answer back here. Bombers obviously been great on the penalty kill all year. With this Battleford power play, they got a lot of weapons, and they're not afraid to use them.
So Battleford in the opening round against Melville. 3-14, not bad, 21.4%. The Bombers, best penalty kill in the regular season, best penalty kill in the postseason. At 90%, gave up a couple power play goals in the opening series here to Kindersley, and a shorthanded goal as well. Porter along the boards, gets it back to Isaac. This is Keegan Bell, shoots it! And that one knocked down, never made it through to the goaltender. Porter will get the rebound. Here's Porter to the blue line, poked away, great job by McNutt. Porter goes back to get it to his own blue line. Here comes Porter to center. Porter across the Flint Flon line, he'll hang on. Dropped it back to Keegan Bell. Swings it over to Isaac. He had a tough time picking it up. Now he has it. He'll shovel off the board. Porter's got it. Back to Bell. He'll be the table setter. Lobs it in. Flintlock trying to get a hold of it. Can't knock it down. Sinclair, look out. Stick knocked out of his hands. Bombers trying to clear Piccinito. Can't get a stick on it. Sinclair took it from him to get the puck to the line. Held in. Keegan Bell. Hangs on. Shoots it. Oh, big save. Just rolls past the post. They jab it in from behind the net. I think Sinclair is going to get credit for it. Or Porter, rather. Keegan Bell, that's how dangerous he is. He just missed, it grazed the post, and they bank it in from behind the net. I think it's Porter, and just like that, we're back even at two.
Yeah, and the Bombers struggling a little bit, had the puck down in the corner, trying to get it out, and then they find...
Yeah, they had multiple chances.
Yeah, and they had two, but then they found themselves two guys caught down in the corner. Keegan Bell is just at the point, left side point, puts on a shot, just goes over Harmon Laser Hume. But then they're able to jam it in on the rebound, and wow, all tied up now.
Porter's third in the playoffs, and they got a lot of weapons, like you said. Their power play looked really good. And again, Keegan Bell was the table center back at the blue line. He made it all happen.
Oh, absolutely.
I missed the second assist on that one. We'll get it after. Here's a steal. Waldy or Isaac gets the assist. Well, that's the second assist on the power play goal. And we're back to two apiece here, so that... Stars do exactly what they did in the opening period, the answer to the Bomber goal.
And that's what they need to do. You know what? They can't let this Bomber team get any momentum, because in this Whitney Forum crowd, well, that's exactly what this Bomber team lives off of, is the momentum, the fans, all that. And right now, Battleford's doing a pretty good job of taking that away from them.
16:46 to play in the second period. 23-9 is the shot in favor of Flint Flon, but it's a 2-2 game as the Stars strike on the power play, Porter's third of the playoffs. Ferguson, he's got a goal tonight as well. We'll take the faceoff here against Walker. Throws it back to Olsen to go all the way down the ice. And Olsen's got a race after. Did they get the replay? Did they show the replay of how that goal went in up on the board?
No, they did not.
I wonder if it was redirected. What happened? Here's a chance now for the Stars. Anderson stops across the Bomber line.
Lost it along the boards. Picked up by Hull. Ahead to Sepp. One guy to beat. It's Olsen at center. Colin Sepp. Good move. Sepp tried to finish it up. He gets it in deep. Great effort by him. Because he'll push the puck back to the battle. Prevent somebody lost a helmet here. It's Olsen. He's going to have to get off the ice here. Meanwhile, football can't hold it. And it gets away from Leffler. Stepping on the ice. Look out. Real visit.
That was a close one, too, Rob.
I know. Great Clemence from the Battleford bench. He's not happy with this call. Too many men on the ice. That's a tough break. So Crow looked like he was off to the races there.
Yeah, absolutely. You
I'd
know
love
what?
To see the replay on that.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening with the replay. It looks like something maybe a little frozen. Not too sure why, but that was a close one, Rob. If anything, he may have just had the tip of his skate on the ice still. But, wow, what a break there for the Bombers.
Well, hopefully we'll get a look at this replay here. I'd like to see that again. I'm sure the North Stars would as well.
Absolutely.
Although they're out of it right now. Well, how did it look to you?
Honestly, Rob, I thought it looked pretty good. I didn't think it was too many men. I thought it was a pretty clean breakaway for Battlefords.
Well, maybe we'll get that replay today at some point, but they're struggling up on the other side here to get a look at it.
Some technical difficulties, that's for sure. But yeah, Rob, in my opinion, it looked like he made it off just in time. I thought it was pretty clear.
Well, the bench is pretty adamant about it.
Yeah, I can see their frustration, but like I said, big break for the Bombers.
Anyway, flip one of the Pepsi power play for the second time here tonight. Bob Wood, our Pepsi power play contestant, gets his products at Walmart. Good luck to him at the Bombers score on the power play. He'll win a full pack of Pepsi, courtesy of Arctic Beverages. You're looking to do their Pepsi Cola in Northern Manitoba, Saskatchewan. During the delay here, let's talk about the NHL playoffs. What a game last night in the Royce Johnson Arena. What a series between the Blizzard. You're going to wave this off. What a series between the Blizzard and the Dauphin Kings. We had a 5 overtime grid. We had triple overtime last night. We had double overtime in a row. I think they played like 14 additional periods of that series.
It was. They had, yeah, it was 2 overtime games earlier on, and then last 2 games, a 5th, and then a 3rd overtime. So between the last 3 games and essentially 16 periods of hockey, Rob, absolute madness. But congratulations to the OCM Blizzard, or the Blizzard as they're now called, on going to the next round. What a great team they have been, especially near the end of the season, going on a 14-1 run and now going to the next round. A great job over there for the Blizzard.
Yeah, Riley, see the winner in triple overtime. But you were right, Austin. They're not going to count this as a power play. Austin Mattis, not just the best color man in the league for nothing, folks. He picked up on that before the officials and benches did, said it was not too many men. And obviously, they concurred downstairs. They agree with you.
Absolutely, Rob. It looked pretty clean from up here.
There you have it. So we're going to stay at 5 aside. The officials have a conference. They come up with the right call, and we're back underway. Max, look out. He caught that puck up. Stolen here by Sinclair. Back to point. That one just rifled wide. Battleford looks like they got a little bit of rhythm after that as well. Sepp can't pick it up. Sinclair to steal a shot off the blocker that time of the Bomber netminder, Harvard Laser Hughes. Sepp looked like he wanted to pin it up. Now he'll move it. Sepp, he's had a nice game tonight in the center. He'll backhander down the ice and steered away to the corner that time by Cunningham. Gilbert, he tried to make something happen. He pins up, I think it's Metternack he's got a hold of. Isaac, the big D-man, knocked it down. He'll throw it outside the zone. Going to roll in on net. Save made Laser Hill. Flip it ahead to Bax. Bax gets it back to Piccinino. Down the right side, here's Justin Lees across the line. Somebody lost the stick, it's Piccinino. Isaac back of the battle for net. He'll play it up the boards. Picked up by Williams. Here's a good pass as he finds Grill at center. Jordan Grill across the line. Jordan Grill! Great move! Walks in, throws it out front. There's a good save by Laser Hillman. Jordan Grill. Shades of Bobby Orr and Paul Coffey back in the day, the way he moved that puck up the ice.
Yeah, Battleford's really putting on the pressure now. Bombers kind of had the edge there in the first period, but now this Battleford's team really putting on the rockets here, getting some huge rushes and really putting on the pressure in the offensive zone.
14:58 to go, second period, a 2-2 game. Oh, just an exciting electric atmosphere here at the Whitney Forum again tonight. Tell you what, if you're in Flint Pond, the surrounding area, you really need to get down here and watch this game live. Nothing beats it. Yeah, Flow TV's fantastic. It's on the radio and all that stuff, but watching it live, nothing beats it.
Yakupchuk back of his net, being forced there. He'll drop it back to McNutt. McNutt's got it. Played it back to Yakupchuk. Nice pass to Anderson at center. He'll flip this one in for Piccinino. Trying to get away from Grill. Anderson up the boards. Stars get it to center to get slap, and he'll rip it in. Yakupchuk back there to get it. Here's Yakupchuk. Nice pass to Piccinino, but knocked away. On the stick of Justin Lees. He's across the line. Looking for somewhere to maneuver it. Throws it in. Picked up by Piccinino. Piccinino back of the goal. Knocked off the play by Grill, the veteran. Off the glass. He'll send it back to the Bomber blue line. Here's Houle. Noah Houle forced back in by Fortner. Noah Houle inside his own zone. Leaves it there. This is Leppert. The young 18-year-old defenseman out of Brandon. Leppert. What a future he's got. Stars taking it center. They'll flip it back in. There's Noah Houle in the corner. Noah Houle up the boards. Knocked down by Egan, who's got a big goal tonight. Matt Egan looking for the loose puck at center. Oh, big body check on goal. Knocked him down. Olsson feeds it back to Houle. Off the boards. Intercepted this time by the North Stars, Bergeson, and he'll send it in. There's Noah Houle. Takes off a check, feeds it back to Lepper up the right side for Divot, too far. Icing against the Bombers. And the crowd in the Bomber bench doesn't like that. 13-19 to go second period. 24-10, the shots in favor of Flintstone, but not once, twice tonight. But as the Bombers take the lead, the Stars come right back. The first period, it took them 7 minutes to come back and tie it. But tonight, they scored just a minute after Matt Egan put about 2-1.
Yeah, and like I said earlier, that's what you need if you're the Battle for North Stars. You just don't want this Bomber team getting any momentum. And right now for the Bombers, I think this crowd needs to start getting a little bit more behind them. They had some momentum, but right now the crowd a bit more quiet than usual. Obviously hear a bit of the boos right now, but the Bomber fans need to start getting behind this team right now and giving them the momentum they need.
13-19 to go, second period. Ferguson lining up the faceoff against Olsson inside the football zone to the right of the netminder, Harmon Leeser-Hume. Off the draw. They throw it back out front. Bouncing quick. Cunningham coming up here to the Bombers. As Cunningham will make his way to the box for the extra attacker. Here's a chance. Fired in front. Knocked down. Almost to the touch. And we got a hooking penalty coming up here.
Yeah, it's going to be on Houle, I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
The Bomber D-man will take the penalty. So the Stars will get the second power play of the night. And I guess the fans West feel that Flintstone never deserves a penalty.
No, you got that right, Rob. And you know what? Got to give credit. We talked about how great the coaching is for both of these teams, but you can see a huge shift in the defensive play style right now, Battleford, since they've come out in the second period. And huge credit to Brain Slamasco for making those adjustments. You can definitely see the difference.
Absolutely, Sinclair to line up against Leeds based off back of the flip-flop zone. The Stars already a power play goal tonight. Isaac, out front to Fortner. He drove it over top of the net. He's got the power play goal. Flip-flop will send it down the ice. Save made here by Cunningham, and Isaac will pick it up back of the goal. A minute 45 on the power play. Feeds the pass back to Porter at center. He'll lift it in. You talk about how good Bell and Isaac are. This Ben Porter, a pretty good player, too. Isaac will hold it in the blue line. Along the boards, there's Porter in the corner. Picked up here by Blake to Porter. Puck redirects, comes out front. Flip on chance, jump on another chance. They score. Power play goal. Porter gets drilled by McNutt after the play. That could be a penalty as well. The Stars in front. Back-to-back power play goals here by the North Stars.
And the Bombers just get caught scrambling. There's a loose puck. Breathe and go right after it, right at the crease. No one can get on it.
Porter's been fantastic tonight.
Yeah, on all season. But yeah, puck just kind of scrambled. Loose puck out in front. Three Bombers go for it. And just a nice low backhand pass just to the high slot. Portner's there. Puts her home. And the Bombers killing themselves right now with the penalties. They just gotta be a bit more disciplined right now, but a huge goal there for the Battle for the North Stars, and now they definitely took the momentum away.
Stars take their first lead of the game on another power play goal by Porter, and they'll jump ahead 3-2 with 12 and a half to play in this second period. Three goals and 11 shots for the North Stars here in this game. Here's Max, Jack Clare. Sinclair and Blake will get the assists on the power play goal by Porter, his second of the game, fourth of the playoffs. Egan throws it in. Got to chase it down, ties up back of the goal. Olsson in there to dig the puck free as well. Grabbed here by Metternach off the boards, and he'll feed it down the ice. Icing called. And look out, McNutt, he's asking for a penalty here. He got to hold that puck, and he ripped it along the boards down the ice. You got to be careful here. These referees nowadays, they don't put
Lilly. You can tell this Battle of Firsts team now definitely getting under the skin of this Bombers team. And if you recall, back when the Bombers played in Battle of Firsts, Adam McNutt got that game-winning goal. So definitely a little bit of history with him in this Battle of Firsts team, and we're seeing that right now.
Another big face-off inside the North Star zone to the right of Logan Cunningham. Oh boy, how important are those saves he made in the first period to keep his team in it now. His team has jumped ahead. 3-2, puck sent back down the ice on Laser Hill. He'll stop that and shovel it over to McNutt. McNutt back to Joey Lees. Throws it in. Here's a chance for Carroll, but Cunningham will play to the corner. Cunningham raced, or Carroll rather, raced in there and had a beeline to the net. Carroll goes down. Puck picked up here by Gold. He'll skate with it from with the Stars to center. Around the board, back in football territory. McNutt can't pick it up. Raskin there looking for it. Good job by McNutt to lift it off the glass back down the ice. They can hit a light, and I think they're going to blow it down. And we got another faceoff back in football territory. The crowd kind of being taken out of the game here a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. And like I said, that's what the Bombers need. You know what? Even being down 1-2 unanswered goals, the Bomber crowd needs to get into this because that's what this Bomber team feeds off of, is that energy. And right now, definitely feeling a little deflated. You can see it reflect to the Bombers on the ice.
And partner, two goals tonight. He'll line up for the faceoff back inside the flip-flops. Go to the right of Harmon Lazenhill, Jacob Bachler. He'll get there for the faceoff. Flip-flop. Down a goal. For the first time in the playoffs, they're trailing in a hockey game. Here's Grell a chance, and he ripped it over top of the net. We talked about the Stars, though. Comeback kids all year. There's a chance. Fired on target. Lazenhill, good save. Rebound picked up by Semka. Lifted ahead to McNutt. He'll slap it back in. There's Gilbert. Back of the goal, Gilbert got out of position, but Bachler was there to pick it up and help him out. Trying to throw it out front, Semp was there. Bombers trying to dig a breach on the back of the net, and look out, Gilbert will take a couple extra swipes to corner here, and you got to be really careful, but with any type of stick work, it can be called.
Oh yeah, temper, especially when tempers are flaring these two teams. The refs are, you know, I think it's been a pretty fair call so far. Refs to kind of let them play, but as the game goes on, guys getting more aggressive. That whistle's definitely going to start being blown more, so both teams got to be careful.
10:50 to go, second period, almost at the midway point of the game already. The Bombers doubling the Stars and shot 24-12, but they are behind 3-2 on a couple of power play goals by Ben Porter. The difference right now, and of course the fine play of their goaltender, Logan Cunningham. Here's Hull to center. Laid it back to Justin Leeds, he's onside. Dishes it off. Chance in front, open net, Piccinino can't get there. Nice setup. Here's Leffer for the blue line. Shot, bouncing puck, Flip-Flop trying to jump on it. Lees can't get a stick on it. Picked up here by the Stars, but they can't clear. Held in by Anderson. Anderson, then shoots it over top of the right pad that time of the goaltender Cunningham. Waldy will finally pick it up, and he'll get it back to center. Great chances there for the Bombers. He'll throw it in tight. Picked up this time by Anderson of the Stars. Back up, but Lees intercepts. Lees in his own zone. Plays it up the middle. Finds Carter Anderson on a rope. Good pass. Artis Anderson a shot. Off the glove here, Cunningham. Shooting it all the way as he got in across the line. Puck picked up. Lifted off the boards that time by Anderson of the Stars. Tanchuk is there. Feeds it back to Bax. Bax gets it to center. Here comes Niven. Niven across the line. Oh, he tried to feather that in. He had Olsson open, but he just missed him. Niven will get it in deep. Right point for Bax. Knocked it down. Shot out front. Didn't miss by much. Good pressure here by the Bombers. Looking to tie this game up. Niven can't knock it down. Puck comes out. Poked back down in football territory. Bax will try to get there before Getzlaff. He does. And low down for an icing call with 9:27 to go in this second period. Boy, football coming close, but no cigar.
Yeah, they're getting the good opportunities, and oh, it feels like you can almost see the goals, Rob, and they're just about a millimeter away with the timing. Just can't seem to get the puck on the stick on those wide open nets, but you know what? You can got a sense that something's going to happen soon.
Face off, one by the Stars. They'll get it down the ice. Ethan take it down. Bombers looking for a penalty. They're going to get one. There is a Bomber power play coming up here. Bax will go back and get it. So Egan taken down, Flip-Flop will be on the power play. Boy, Tanchuk looks gassed here. Just gets rid of it. Oh, he might be shaking, he might be hurting, but could he block a puck off his leg?
I don't know, but yeah, usually you don't see him like that.
I think he might be hurt. Anyway, I guess since we were going to give Bob what a chance on that power play, it didn't happen. I guess we'll go with him again. Bob Wendrick are going to pass 5 minutes of Pepsi after all. Once again, he gets his products at Walmart. Rask will get the penalty. We've got a media timeout. We'll take a break. Back with the Bomber Power Play. Trying to tie the game. Stars in front 3-2 here on 1029 CFER and footballonline.com.
Absolutely. You can see the difference out there.
Justin Lees trying to feed it back. Flint can't hold it in again. It gets past Hull. Good penalty killing again by the North Stars. Hull will go back to collect the puck back of his net. 1:25 to go in the power play. Here's the pass to Walker. Threads the needle to Anderson. Anderson, 22 power play goals the regular season. He was electric. He's got a power play goal as well, or two power play goals so far in the playoffs, but they can't keep the puck in. Walker better hurry. Sinclair coming in on him. He just got rid of it. Boy, this Bomber power play cannot get down the ice. Down to 1:05 to go. Here's Hull. Back to Justin Leeds. Nice pass to Walker. Walker gets it back to Hull. Hull will get a hold of it. He'll drill it in. Leeds in pursuit. Knocked it down. Came back up front to Anderson. Can't hold it in. Great penalty killing again by the Stars. Down the ice it goes. And Noah Hull looking confused. He goes back to get it. They can't figure out why they can't penetrate that Battleford wall. He'll try again. The stretch pass to Piccinino. He's across the line. Piccinino, good move along the boards. Piccinino hangs on, throws it up front. Nice pass, but got a chance. And there's an opportunity. Puck is loose. And Cunningham will eventually grab it, which will bear on the doorstep. And Piccinino, a couple of nice moves there to give them pretty much the only scoring chance they've had on this power play.
Yeah, finally some good opportunities there on the power play. But Battleford's doing a great job of just holding the blue line there and making it very difficult for the Bombers to get on the attack. So big credit to them. But finally, Piccinino able to open them up, loosen them up a bit, get in there, and finally find some opportunities with a nice pass.
Another faceoff inside the North Star zone. The Bombers win the draw, but they can't capitalize. Grab set the length of the ice. 20 seconds to go. A laser heel out of the net. And he'll dish it off to the corner to Semp. He plays this one back here to Tanchuk. He's back out there. Semp. Back to McNutt, good move, as he'll throw it in, got it away from Isaac, which isn't easy to do. McNutt throws it out front off the post, it comes up front to Sepp, can't pull the trigger. Knocked off his stick to center, Tanchuk's got it, penalty over. Rask out of the box, and Flip-Flop 0-2 on the power play, and neither power players look good. Here's Isaac. Back up the middle, Williams will redirect that back in Flip-Flop territory. Back's there to get it. Back of his net. Key and Bell after him. He'll try to get away. Poked it ahead. Nice job. Here's Colin Olson. That's to regroup in his own blue line. Key and Bell, a nice forecheck. Here's Back. Back up the middle to Egan. A goal tonight. We'll redirect it into the glove. Cunningham will stop that. And hang on. With 6:38 remaining here. In the second period remains a 3-2 lead here for the North Stars. The other game tonight just underway. No score with about 8 minutes to go in the opening period. Humboldt-Melfort, who you got in that series?
Well, you know what? That's going to be a good one, but I think Melfort's going to take it. But you know what? Humboldt is definitely going to give him a good fight there, Rob.
Well, the second half of the season, they were so good, both those teams down the stretch. Wavered, but he ultimately scared him in the opening round. I think that's a 6 or 7 game series, too.
Oh, without a doubt.
off the faceoff, ripped over top of the net that time by Niven. Keehan Bell's got it for the Stars. They'll flip it back up the middle. Grabbed here by Blake, but taken away right away by Niven. He'll feed it back in the zone to Leffer, who quickly gets rid of it to Bass. Here's a nice pass here to Olofsson. Olofsson across the line, dropped it back. Egan again, a shot! Save, it's in behind the goalie, but he reaches back and grabs it. And boy, Kyle and Olofsson and Matt Egan might be the two best Bomber forwards on the ice in this game.
Oh, absolutely. Right now, but you know what? They have so much heart. They are not letting that puck out of their sight. And when they see it, you can almost guarantee they're going to grab it and get it on their stick. And right now, that is what's giving them the opportunities. Just the relentlessness, the persistence to keep going after that puck and finding ways to get shots on net.
You've got to be kidding me. It's 34-14, the shots.
Wow.
Bombers putting the draw. Yakimchuk! Or sorry, Leffer into the glove. Same lead here by Cunningham. 35-14 is the shot for Flint Flon, and they're down 3-2.
Wow, you know what? Like we always say, Rob, you know what? You take lots of shots, but Cunningham doing a great job at saving them, and the Bombers just not getting the saves when they need it.
Ferguson taking the faceoff here against Gruner. Stars win the draw. Off the glass, that'll go up into the Bomber bench, and they'll blow that down with 6:07 to go in the second period here tonight. Second intermission show, a trip down memory lane once again. The Bomber Legend Series, legendary goaltender Harvey Stewart will join us tonight. And Harvey's listening, by the way, out in BC tonight, so big hello to him.
Well, Rob, you always do a great job with those.
Love catching up with the great historic guys, especially all the guys that born and raised in Flint Flon, played all his minor hockey here. His wife's from Flint Flon, and had a great chat with him the other day. Looking forward to, of course, having him on the broadcast here in our second intermission tonight. No doubt he's hoping for a Bomber goal like the rest of us, trying to tie this game up. And the Stars right now in control. Bergeson down the way, gets a shot. Didn't miss by much. Olsen will hold it in. Bergeson went down hard back of the net. Right back up, though. Centers it! An opportunity that time for Anderson. Just missed. We got, looks like back shaking up on the play. Terrell will get the puck out. A pass to Lees. This is Joey Lees for Flint Flon. Down the wing, a shot. And steered away. Oh, we got another penalty coming up, Laser. He'll made his way to the bench here.
Yeah, that was when Bax, you saw Bax take a fall there. Yeah, he looks like he got tripped up there, kind of behind the play. So Bombers with another man advantage here.
So Flint Flon will try to get something going on their third power play in the game, but not been able to do much on the first two chances. We'll see if they can tie things up. Of course, the Stars, a couple of power play goals tonight, and Royce Pesce-Keys are such a big part of what happens. Guy Weary, our Pepsi power play contestant this time around, also gets his products at Walmart. Guy, a big Bomber supporter. Here's Noah Hull. Out the faceoff. He ripped it wide. Had a lot of room there. Anderson in the corner. Leaves it there for Gruner. Anderson back of the goal. Flipped it in. Walker comes in to get it. In the corner for Leeds. Back to the point for Hull. Hull has it. Dishes it off. Picked up by Walker. Side of the goal for Leeds. Tried to feather that through, but it hit a stick. Walker trying to jam it in. But a good save again by Cunningham. No hole holds it in. A lot better looking power play this time. Back to Locker. Locker's got it. Leeds scores! Justin Leeds on the power play. And he's tied things up. Too much room for him. I think he put that through 5-hole.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what? A very smart shot to stop if you're Cunningham. That's basically right at the goal line, bottom of the left circle, and just able somehow to get that through. And I think you're right, Rob. I think that was possible. But an absolute great job by Justin Leeds to find the tight opening there in between Cunningham and just put it through. What a goal.
Leeds is team leading fifth of the playoffs. Congratulations, Guy Leary. All around good guy. You've won yourself a 12-pack of Pepsi, courtesy of Arctic Beverages, your local dealer of Pepsi Cola in Northern Manitoba, Saskatchewan. Tatchuk along the boards here to Egan. Flint Flon tied it. He can't afford to get the lead up. There's a shot by Porter. Looking for the hat trick. He fanned on it. Didn't miss by much. And Bombers in disarray in their own zone. Keehan Bell is in there. He'll flip it in deep. Egan after it. Can't clear it. Held in here by Porter. Puck came out there. They say no. Now it comes out. Walker and Hull will get the assist on the power play goal here by Justin Leeds, but the Stars come back. That come back so close to retaking the lead. Bax swings the pass ahead to Olofsson. Olofsson will track it down. He'll bring it in deep. Going in wide this time on Granger. Puck back to the battle for goal. Stars moving ahead to Bell. Keehan Bell will feather the pass. It's Blake to center. Blake hangs on. Shoots. Washington ripped that one wide. He had a guy cutting the front of the net as well. Trail fires it on target, kicked away by Laser Hugh. Boy, the Stars are really, seem like they're more motivated after that goal than Flipwan is. Pichettino with the steal. Flipwan back the other way. Pichettino falls down, loses the handle. They try to hit the stretch pass that time to Williams, just passed him. Icing called. And Flipwan's tied it with 3:34 to go in the second period. A boy really dominating the shot so far. 37-15, but it's a 3-3 game.
Yeah, absolutely, and I think you're right, Rob. You know what? The Bombers got to be careful. Every time they've scored a goal, they're letting Battleford come back and
well,
get another.
Well, they came close a couple times there.
Well, exactly, and Ben Portner, really a man on a mission right now, just somehow skating through everyone. Puts on a nice shot, but does not go. Good thing for the Bombers.
Faceoff back in Battleford territory. 17 shots for the Bombers in this period alone. Pichettino, Lees, and Anderson up front for the Bombers. It's Poole and Leper on the back end. Puckle. Make its way to the Bomber blue line. There's Leper. The dangerous Williams on him. Got him to turn it over because he knocked him off the play. You can't hang on the puck for too long. They're going to take it away from you. But want to clear it out. Justin Lees has got the tying goal. Poked it ahead. Anderson trying to get free. He's knocked to the ice. Sinclair throws it back to center. Picked off by Hull. He'll send it in. Long shot stopped by Cunningham. Dropped it back to the goal this time for Olsen. Lees comes back to grab it at center. Justin Lees ahead to Pichettino. He'll flip it in. Under three to go with the second period. Boy, what a game here tonight. Anderson with the steal in the corner. Try to pin it up there. Walker in there as well. Fed the pass to Lees on the tying goal. Walker, of course, the guy's had a lot of success in the playoffs the last few years as well. Sent along the boards. Cat knocking away. Stolen by Anderson. Back to the goal. Tried to come out front. Cunningham redirected it. Comes back to center. Grabbed here by Leper. He'll lift it in. Well over the glass and out of play. With 2:27 to go in the second period. Big time goal here by the Bombers on the power play. Finally got the power play going.
Yeah, huge one that they needed. Like you kind of mentioned, those first couple power plays. Just didn't seem like they really had the will. Didn't seem like they were too eager to score. But you know what? Finally, when they find themselves down 3-2, second period's kind of dwindling down a bit. They finally realized, you know, this is the time to do it. And who other than Justin Lees to get that goal for him?
It's 3-3, just over 2 minutes to go. Here's Nick Dutt for Flintmont. Feeds it back. Yakupchuk up the wing. Bachner in full flight. Down the wing. A shot. Glove save made by Cunningham. Bachner starting to find his game here in the second period.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what? I know him and Alexis Silvestri, he's definitely missing him out there tonight, but definitely doing a great job with the line mates now. Able to receive that nice stretch pass, find the opening. And you're just hoping, if you're the Bombers, that Cunningham's eventually going to start opening up a little bit.
2:15 to go in the third. The Bombers hold it in. Isaac, the big D-man, will get it back to center. Picked up here by Anderson of the Stars and flipped in. And before he knocks Yakupchuk to the ice, McNutt will rip it in with. Ferguson there, though. Shoots a good glove save that time, Laser Hugh. He'll make the save and hang on. With 2:02 to go, big faceoff here inside the Flintmont zone.
Yeah, Bombers, honestly, have been pretty good. I'd say the draws have been about 50-50 tonight. And Bombers, they need this one here. They don't want to find themselves back in the defensive zone here with 2 minutes left. And this Battleford team has been putting on some good pressure. This is not the position you want to be in. So a huge faceoff here for the Bombers with 2 minutes left in the second.
Olsen will take the faceoff against Parker. Two goals for him tonight. Both on the power play. He's been hot. Stars win the draw. They feather it through. Open net. Oh, but he gets there. Trying to get the stretch pass. He had Niven open. He just missed him. Niven must have touched him because icing isn't called. Egan will barrel it there. He's got a goal tonight. Egan picked up back of the goal. What a game here tonight. Game one of this best of seven SJHL semifinal. And if tonight's any indication, Austin, we're in for one heck of a series. But I think everybody knew that.
Oh, yeah.
Isaac on the Star side of center. He's got it. Played it ahead. Blake across the Bomber line. Blake will carry it in. McNutt through the body check. Comes out front. Bell fanned on it. And Niven back to the win. I think Niven's tired. He does. He wants to get off. He'll dump it in for McNutt. He falls down. Puck underneath. He pokes it out front. And racing up the bench is Gruner. Decides to take the long way to get there. Gruner back out front. Joey Lees in his skates. He's not sure. Spins and throws it to the corner. Gruner tries to tie up his guy. Sticks flying all over the place. Puck lifts it to Hull. He'll keep it in. 1 minute to play in the second period. Stars get it to the center. Cut off here by Tanchuk. Here's Joey Lees. Lees down the wing. A shot. Kicked away. Rebound. Carroll fell. Backhander. Flipped wide by Gruner. Oh, he missed a wide open net. Puck back of the goal. The Stars will rip it around the boards. Here's Blake.
Back to Leppert. Leppert knocked it away. Did get it out. Boy, that's close to being too many men again. Here's Isaac. He'll send it in. No hole. And Williams shots it away from in the corner. Stars race after it, though, but picked up here by Joey Lees. His backhander makes its way to center. Back to Lees again. Joey Lees to center ice. We'll get a hold of it. Throws it in deep. 16 seconds remaining. Racing in is Carter Anderson, back of the goal. Anderson staying with it. Picks the pocket, gets it out front. There's a chance. Dustin Lees. Spin. Fire. Oh, we got a penalty coming up against the Stars as Anderson was held up here. I thought Lees was going to get that one in.
Oh, I know. And Cunningham was just kind of rolling around. Was in the pad stack, legs up in the air. It was a good opportunity. But even then, Rob was still
maybe
able to...
Maybe a penalty against Flint-Flon, maybe.
Uh-oh, but Cunningham still able to make the save, but finally Bombers getting some real...
Count anyway, I guess, if there's a delayed penalty coming up.
Yeah.
Jacob Bacher going to go for interference here, Austin.
Wow, we did not expect that one. And Jacob Bacher...
Neither did I. Anderson looked like he was held up in front, but...
Bacher usually very disciplined. You don't see him going in the box too often, so very uncharacteristic there. But you know what? Kind of hard to see what was going on as there was a few guys in there, so... But Bomber still good opportunity, putting on the pressure there.
So the Stars, who are 2-for-2 on the power play, will get their third chance of the night. McNutt argues the call. I think for Flintbun, he's going to win this faceoff and get out of here and get rested, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think you want to take any chances. Even just try and tie him up and just kill as much time. You don't want Battlefirst to get a shot here.
5.8 seconds to go. Off the faceoff, Flintbun will chip it out, and they will get it down the ice, and Keith Bell will go back and get it, but he's going to run out of time, at least in the second period. So Bacher takes an interference penalty, and the Stars will begin the third period on the power play. Already 2-for-2 in this game.
You know, very similar to how that last period started. Bombers had the power play going into the second. Now Battlefords have it going into the third. Let's see how it's going to turn out. But right now, all tied up. Both teams playing with that fire in their heart. But the Flint Flon Bombers, I think, got a bit of the edge here, especially with the shots on goal.
We'll run down the second period scoring summary here quickly because we got that lengthy interview with Harvey Stewart coming up with second period scoring summary. Lots of goals here, Austin. It was 1-1 after one. Flint Flon took the quick lead early in the second. Matt Egan got a second chance. Cunningham stopped the first chance, two shot. He gets the rebound, he pops it in. His second of the playoff, and Olsen and backs. Flint Flon up 2-1 at 1:45. But Ben Porter comes back, a couple of power play goals. His third from Bell and Isaac at 2:52. Ben again on the power play at 6:31. Sinclair and Blake the assist. And Flint Flon finally, the power play was their bread and butter all year long. They come back and tie things up. Justin Lee's beautiful goal. Five hole here on Cunningham. Wachter and Hull, the assistant, at the 15:30 mark. And that would tie things up. Lee's his fifth of the postseason, his team leading fifth so far in the playoffs. So shots in that period, all Flint Flon 21-9. The Bombers already tested Cunningham 41 times after two periods. The Stars, 16 shots, but they don't care. They're tied up at 3 after 2. And go to the power play for almost a full 2 minutes when we come back in the third period.
Yeah, honestly looking pretty good from both ends right now. Rob, Bombers kind of doing exactly what they want. Only kind of downside, like you mentioned, was their power play. Not as productive that we're kind of used to seeing. But rather than that, high pace from the Bombers and lots of good scoring chances. And then Battlefords doing what they do best is looking for the mistakes and capitalizing on them. And clearly they only got 16 shots here. Try out a Realty shot clock. Only 16, but with 3 goals, it's the quality of the shots they're getting, and clearly it's paying off.
That's the story so far after 40 minutes of play, but these two teams are tied up after two in the playoffs. The Battleford record is 1-0. And the Bombers, this is something, have not been tied after two periods of play in their whole opening round against Kindersley. So that's the story so far. We'll take a break. Down memory lane, the Bomber Legend Series with legendary goalie Harvey Stewart. He joined us momentarily here on 1029 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
Spring clear means spring cleaning. But based on that,
yeah, I got it.
Your old floral couch didn't get the memo.
Ew, gross.
So upgrade to a new one with Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center. Check out their wide selection of sofas, sectionals, love seats, and recliners from some of the biggest brands that you love and trust. And with tons of different styles, you're sure to find something you love. It's time to get rid of that stinky old furniture and breathe in that fresh spring air with Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center.
It's good.
go time at Frontline Sport Leisure. Get into the spring of things with huge savings so you can not only think outside, but dominate the outdoors. Save up to $1,500 on select Polaris ATVs, $2,000 off select Rangers and Expeditions, and $3,000 off Razor models. Frontline Sport and Leisure wants you to work and play outside and save big while you're at it. Take advantage of the It's Go Time sales event. Breakthrough with ATVs and side-by-sides at Frontline Sport and Leisure on Coronation Drive in Creighton, 688-3333.
Good evening and welcome to our second intermission tonight. As promised, it's more of our Flint Fawn Bomber Legends series, as this time we're joined by, once again, one of the Flint Fawn Bombers from the Western Canadian Hockey League days in the early 70s. Born and bred goaltender Harvey Stewart's going to join us. He played for the Flint Fawn Bombers between 72 and 74. Was draft pick for the LA Kings, was a draft pick for Cleveland of the WHA, and of course had a chance to play with one of the most illustrious organizations in the history of junior hockey. Harvey joins us tonight from Delta, BC. Harvey, good to catch up with you, and I think it's an interview that a lot of people look forward to hearing again. Not only did you play for the Bombers, but of course born and bred in Flin Flon, and played with a lot of tremendous guys locally and abroad. It was, I'm sure playing for the Bombers was one of the highlights of your hockey career, if not the highlight of your hockey career.
Well, that is absolutely positive there, Rob, as far as growing up in Flin Flon, which is a hockey haven, as everybody knows. I was fortunate enough to play with some real awesome young fellows right from the get-go. So graduating to the junior team and getting drafted was quite awesome.
Listen, we're going to talk a lot about your junior Bomber days, but we got to talk about your minor hockey days, too. You and I had a chance to chat before we went to air, and a lot of the guys, I mean, everybody remembers, of course, the glory days of the junior Bombers, but you guys had a terrific minor hockey system here. There was always not only a good contingent of local players on the junior team, but always very good local players. And you were telling me that a lot of the guys you played minor hockey with graduated with you to the junior program.
That's correct, Rob. Yeah, I was counting, going back in some of my old scrapbooks, that almost half of the team, the junior Bomber team, were born and raised right in Flin Flon. And we got, over the years, Pee-wee, Bantam, Midget. We took the province every year. We ended up in Midget and Swift Current, taking all of Western Canada. So, unbelievable bunch of guys that I grew up with.
And a chance to play with them, like we said, on the junior team. In particular, let's talk about your goaltending partner, Roger Swanson, another local born and bred player from Flin Flon. I'm assuming you guys played minor hockey all together and, of course, had a chance to start with the junior team as well in the early 70s.
Yeah, Raj went to Winnipeg, and I think he was playing for Kirkfield back in the early days. And like you said, he was born and raised in Flin Flon, but we didn't really play together in the younger days.
Okay. But you had a chance to play together on the Bombers there. What was that like?
Yeah, it was awesome. You know, we became good friends, and we both, I think Raj played for 3 or 4 years, and I played for 2 years. So I was a year older than Roger, and I was, like I say, drafted in 74. So
what was it like? I mean, I look at the way that the stats, it looked like you guys kind of almost split games down the middle. What was it like playing with him, being a local guy, and I'm assuming that you guys probably kind of tested each other, and it was good competition for one another, was it not?
Yeah, that's true, Rob. I think we respected each other that way, and a lot of alternating in as a two tandem goaltending unit. We did have the split in the second year with the coaching, with Patty Janelle leaving and Mel Pearson coming in, and pretty much when Mel came in, it was pretty much, you know, game here and a game there for each of us.
What was it like with the two coaching styles? Because obviously we know Patty Goodell, what type of coach he was, and Mel was kind of almost the complete opposite personality-wise, wasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Mel was, he was a terrific player in his own right. Portland Buckaroos, he was a superstar out there. But, Patty Goodell was, as you all know, was pretty hard-nosed guy, and there was a lot of tough stuff going on back in those days.
Was that? I know I've talked to other guys that played for both, And a lot of them kind of indicated to me it was a tough adjustment, maybe not for you as much as you being a goalie, but apparently for a lot of the players, it was a real tough adjustment going from Patty to Mel, I've heard from some guys that played during that era.
It was. I think with Mel, he didn't really have the experience as a coach. As we all know, Patty Janelle was a stalwart when it comes to coaching. Him and fellas like Punch McLean out in New Westminster, they were really awesome coaches back in those days.
The thing that always admires me about the game of hockey or being a Bomber is the friendships you develop with the team. And even though it was such a long time ago, and you were telling me it's coming up on the 50th anniversary for you since you played for the Bombers, guys you played with, you're still good friends with today, Harvey.
Absolutely, yeah. I keep in touch with the likes of Dennis Polinich, Jerry Rollins. My closest friends were like Al Hilliard, Dallione, Wayne Bray, and my best friend was Robbie Watt.
All great hockey players, and you also told me that you're married to Blaine Stoughton's cousin.
That's correct, yeah. We got married in 81. I met her in 77 in Winnipeg.
Now, you had a chance to play with Blaine for the 1 year. What type of player was he like? What was it like playing with him?
Blaine was just a superstar in all regards. Maybe didn't have the greatest work ethic, but he was the absolute sniper. And he went on to have an illustrious career, both in the NHL and the WHA.
And like you mentioned, the only one of two guys to score 50 goals in both leagues.
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, we still keep in touch all the time.
Yeah, absolutely. Listen, Harvey, what did it mean to be, tell me what it was like being a Bomber back in the day, what it meant for you being a local guy coming up through the Flint Farm Minor Hockey System. Let's backtrack a little bit, what it meant for you to be a Bomber, and just kind of all in all, what it was like riding those long bus rides, just all a day in the life of a junior hockey player in Flint Farm back then. What was it like? What do you remember?
Well, first of all, the only thing I ever wanted to do was to play hockey, so that kind of summed it all up. And then getting a chance to play right up into junior hockey and get drafted was absolutely amazing. The bus rides, just the camaraderie with all of the buddies. We had a great bunch of guys, and I can't ever remember having any problems. And we all got along so well, and I guess a lot of cohesion that way.
One of the first things that guys asked me that I touched back with from your era about the chicken wire around the Whitney Farm, it's synonymous. That's one of the first things that Gene Carr asked me. I know Blaine Stoughton brought it up, other guys I've talked to as well. What are your memories of that chicken wire they had at the Whitney Farm back in the day?
Yeah, well, that was something else, all right. Although I didn't have to worry about getting smashed into it from the other players. It was very different. And then early on, I don't know if it was our era or not, but I remember watching the Junior Bombers, and there wasn't even anything along the sideboard. All there was the boards, and then the fans were right there. They would grab on the players, and it was... That was pretty crazy.
No question about it. I remember guys telling me behind the player's box there wasn't any glass either, right?
Yeah.
Definitely a different era for sure. Of course, the Whitney Farm has changed a lot since you've been at the rink last, but we'll talk a little bit more about that here in the next couple of minutes. But let's talk about your career after hockey. Like you mentioned, like I've mentioned, you got drafted in the 7th round by the LA Kings and by the Cleveland Crusaders in the WHA, both in the same year, both in the 7th round. Obviously, you wanted to make the transformation to professional hockey. Take me to your career after you left the Bombers and got drafted. I know you played some years in the minors. Take me back to what was happening then.
Yeah, originally I was offered a contract with Kings, which this player agent I had reneged on it. And then I thought, well, maybe I'd have a better opportunity to play for, in the Cleveland Crusader organization in the W. And, I think one of the biggest disappointments was I got drafted by two two teams that probably had two of the best goaltenders in hockey at the time, and that was Rogie Vachon in L.A. and Jerry Cheevers in Cleveland.
Right.
So it was, go to camp, dry out, okay, then they send you down. And the minor league system that I was involved in, I didn't really enjoy it that much. So after a couple of years, I decided I guess I'm going to have to work for a living. So I ended up playing senior hockey in Winnipeg, and that got me involved in a good job working for a wholesale building distributor, which was Weldwood of Canada. And then I got shipped out to Vancouver to play for, in 78, I could backtrack a little bit, Rob. In 78, when I was playing senior hockey in Winnipeg, I got a call up from the Winnipeg Jets, and I ended up being with the Jets as a backup to Marcus Mattson, because Joe Daly was injured.
Okay.
And they kept me on for the rest of the year that year. And John Ferguson was involved. I dressed for many games, road trips, and then I was sort of like the third goaltender with them for practicing and whatnot, so doing some stats work.
Was Kim Claxton there then?
He was not there then.
Okay.
So I think he was still playing with the Nordiques.
Okay, fair enough, because I remember he spent some time with the Winnipeg Jets as well.
Yeah, he did, yeah. But that was quite a thrill. That year I turned 25, but my wife, my girlfriend then, but her and her sister had a party, and a lot of the Jets were there, like Morris Lukowicz.
210.
Might have to dump it. We'll let you know.
Can't even recall all the other teams, but anyways, it was quite a thrill.
Yeah, and that was a marquee team back then.
Yeah, they were pretty good. That was the year that Nelson and Hedberg went to New York, and Lars-Eric Sjöberg retired. So, and then Bobby Hull, of course, was retired just previous to that as well. So, but I got to hang out with a lot of those guys as well.
That's a great story. That's kind of a nice way to wind down your career, is it not?
Absolutely, yeah. And then, like I said, I transferred out to Vancouver with work.
Hey, Raphael, you can fade it out.
It was Dave Rainville, former Flint Flyer, who was...
And you're on.
All righty, we apologize. We couldn't quite get the full interview in, but most of it right to catch up with Harvey Stewart. Don't worry, we'll run that again in North Battleford next week. We're underway in the third period of a 3-3 game. The Stars on the power play. Isaac will rip. Oh, took a buddy hot, came right out front there. Bombers cleared ahead. That's Niven at center, knocked away from him. Olofsson has been terrific again for Flint Flon tonight. We'll flip it in. Minute 28 to go in the power play, just underway in the third in a 3-3 hockey game. Here's the pass to Portner across the Bomber line. Made a good move for the hat trick. He ripped it wide. Bell will hold it in. Back to blue line. It goes to Isaac. Isaac dropped it back to Bell. Isaac, a shot. Look out. Knocked out in front. Open net again. And the puck set down. Leeds loses his stick here. Bell goes back to get it in his blue line. It looked like it. I think Laser Hume lost sight of where that puck was there, Austin.
Oh, absolutely. Piccinino with the big stick, though, to stop it.
Flint Flon will try to get jump back on it. It's back of the goal. Watch Portner. He's been dangerous. Throws it back and then picked up here by Piccinino. He found on it. Portner in the corner. Side of the goal. Stars work it back up front. It gets away from Isaac and will roll down the ice. 40 seconds left on the power play. Kean Bell. He'll have to go back and get it with Olofsson on top of him. He'll drop it back of the goal. Olsen is there to get it. Olsen up the boards. Here's the captain. And Grill will dump it in. Niven for Flint Flon back around the board. Bell. He can't grab it, but Olsen will hold it in. Plays it back over to Grill. This is Olsen. Top of the right circle for Bell. He's got it. Side of the goal. Trying to jam it in. A good chance that time for Gregor. Just missed. Olsen shorthanded. 10 seconds to go. He'll get the center. Dropped it back to Niven. A backhander on target. Kicked away that time by Cunningham. Olsen gets the rebound. Needs it back to Leppard. He'll dump it back in. And Olsen has it. Penalty over. Olsen down the wing. Across the line. He'll carry it in. Lepper grabbed the puck back, goes up, decides to throw it back in a big maze of players here. Also pinned up was sent for Flint Flon. The Stars, Metternak comes away with it, gets away from his check along the boards. Metternak tied up with Lepper. Williams, he's hauled down. Flint Flon back the other way. Walker to center. He'll lift it in.
into the glove, grabbed here by Cunningham, but a big penalty kill here by Flint Flon.
Yeah, that's exactly what the Bombers needed. They needed to stop that one. They definitely didn't want to give Battleford's one right out the start of the period. And just great efforts from the Bombers to really make it difficult. Still some good chances for the North Stars, but nothing finds the back of the net. And just what the Bombers need here.
McDonald's out of town scoreboard. They're scoreless Humboldt Melford early in the second period. And that could be a series that's tough to score on. James Benn is a nominee for the MVP of the league. He's been fantastic his entire career in the SJHL, always tough to beat. And Benjamin Motu, Austin, what a series he had against the Weyburn Red Wings. He gets himself an NCAA scholarship, has been fantastic. You might not see a lot of goals scored in that other series.
Oh, no, not at all, Rob.
Waldy down the ice, he's looking for Williams. Yakimchuk looks tired to me. He'll throw it back to the goal to Joey Lees, who comes back. Tell you what, in this series, we're tired. You got to get off the ice. Carroll will dump it back in. Incredible speed out there both ways. You're going to see guys gas probably quite regularly. Meanwhile, Jordan Grill up the right side, across the Bomber line. Grill poked away in the corner that time by Tanchuk. Tanchuk trying to play it up the boards. Bax has got a hold of his guy, but Grill's got the puck. Centers it out front. Bouncing puck gets away. It comes back to center. Picked up here by Karkin. He'll rip it back in Flint Flon territory. Just underway in the third period. Bax overskated it. Here's a steal by the Stars. Out front! Knocked down in front. A saver possibly by Tanchuk. He stopped that puck on a bad giveaway by the Bombers in their own zone. Here's Carter Anderson the other way. He tries to get turned around, knocked to the ice, back to the goal for Justin Lees. He'll rim it to the right point, the backs. Knocked it down, tries to hold it in. Stars knock it away, gets slapped. He'll slap it back at football territory. 50-50, almost at 20 grand, Austin, as we got 60 minutes remaining in this third period. $20,000 to 50-50.
You know, Rob, I think I might have told you this, but over this entire season alone, the Flint Flon Bombers have given away over $134,000 in 50-50.
And I've won none of it.
Neither have I, Rob, so we're on the same boat.
And
here.
I didn't buy a ticket tonight. I forgot all about it, I got to be honest. Oh, well, there's always tomorrow. You know it'll be big again.
Oh, always, always.
Off the glass, Leffer gets a stick on it at center, trying to come back to Gilbert. He can't do anything with it. Take it away from him, going back in the zone. Here's Wachter for Flint Flon. Up the right side. Grabbed here by Sempe. Overskated. He had a great opportunity there to send Gilbert in alone. He'll get to it and rip it back in. Picked up back of the goal this time by the Stars, Olsen. And back to Isaac. Isaac tries to get the puck to settle down for him. He'll flip it ahead. Grabbed at center ice here by Noah Hoole. Noah Hoole. Little trouble. Fouls down. Look, oh, he's going to draw a penalty here. He might be hurt here, Austin.
Yeah, that looks like... Yeah, it looks like he's in, taking a little while to get up from that one, but just...
Got hooked up this time by the North Stars, Ben Porter. He's down, and he's shaking up here. They got a power play coming up.
Well, Robin, you mentioned it earlier. Guys are getting aggressive with the sticks. Both these teams just going stick crazy. And right there, yeah, just takes right under his legs. And Ben Porter, that's the guy you want in the box, too.
Big Al Morrison is our Pepsi power play contestant this time. Al gets his puck from the co-op. Flint Flon, 1-for-3 on the power play here tonight. We'll see what they can do on their fourth chance. Fans are coming to life as they dig in for the faceoff deep in the North Star zone. Bombers win the faceoff. It comes back to Noah Hoole. Here's Schiltner. Double binder! Bachner, a shot on target. Didn't see it was 2 minutes, but it is. What a chance here for Flint Flon. Hoole will hold it in. Anderson back to Hoole. Here's Bachner. Just inside the line, side of the goal. Lees a chance off the side of the net. Looked like Cunningham had that angle covered pretty well. Walk cool in tight again. Sticked away that time by Gold. Picked up here by Gruner. Works it back to blue line. Anderson got a lot of room for him. Back to Hull. Here's Walker. Hangs on. Fans on it. Got the shot through, but easily stopped by Cunningham. Williams will poke it to the blue line. Hull races to keep it in. Here's Walker again. Left side, through traffic, save made, poked out front. Lees a chance, he scores! Another power play goal for the captain, and does it another power play chance. Justin Lees, back-to-back power play goals. Flint Flon retaking the lead.
And when the captain, when you need him most, the captain comes, and he does it right there, Justin Lees. Back-to-back, two huge power play goals, just like
when the Bombers need it, and the hometown kid Justin Lee's getting it done yet again to put the Bombers up one goal. And what a great shot, finds the angle and is able to put it in there. Just high slot area, left circle, oh my.
Lee's his second tonight, it'll be his fifth in the playoffs. And the Bombers are back at 4-3, and they stay on the power play because it was a double minor that was handed out. As we get the announcement of the go-ahead goal, the Bombers will dump it in. Picked up the trotter on the board by Thrill. The puck will come to center, picked up by Sinclair. Sinclair short-handed, a good shot, and kicked away by Laser. Hume had to be ready for that one. Here comes McNutt outside his own zone. McNutt will carry it to center. Adam McNutt down the wing, brings it in deep. McNutt! Oh, good save, Cunningham. Adam McNutt, a tremendous rush coast-to-coast here, trying to put football up by two if they can.
And what a great job by Cunningham to hug that post. A very unsuspecting shot there from that tight angle. Definitely a shot that could have gone in, but Logan Cunningham not taking any chances, doing a great job of hugging that post as he comes flying down the left side.
Monty Beck is our next Pepsi Power Play contestant. Gets this product of the Red Apple. Monty in attendance here tonight, but don't worry, if he wins, we'll tell him. Bombers hold it in. Patrick off the faceoff to Gilbert. Second power play unit is out there. Back of the goal, it goes to Piccinino. Trying to come back to Gilbert. Gilbert will poke it back up front to McNutt. A chance! Kicked away by Cunningham. Big rebound kick from the side of the goal. Picked up and set down the ice this time by Carmen. Laser Hume out of the net. Tanchuk will pick it up. Back of the goal. A minute five to go in the power play. 13:45 in the third. Bachter races down the left side. He'll throw it in deep. Grill after it. Hammer it. Took a funny hop out front. Chance! Big toe save, Bachter on the rebound. Boy, what a chance for Anderson there. And a might be a game saver tonight for Cunningham. What a stop that was. Bouncing puck, Bombers keep it in. Gruner back of the goal. This is Divin to Gruner. Back up front to Hull. Just keeps it in. He'll slide along the wall to Bachter. Back to Hull. Looks for a lane. But Tarepta got blocked that time by Metternach. The battle for bench will cheer that. And a nice shot block. This one holds it in. 28 seconds to go. Hull shot. Save. Loose puck out front. Bachter wanted to shoot it. Somebody doesn't have a stick. It's Grill. Back of the goal. Back out front. Gruner a chance. Blocked again. Nice job that time. Puck bouncing. And grabbed here by Cunningham. Metternach a couple big shot blocks. And Stars saving a couple of goals there, Austin.
Yeah, Metternach, got to give credit. Huge job by him. Really laying his body on the line. And that just shows you this is playoff hockey. Guys, Stars are not afraid to even get hit in the face, hit in the arm, the leg, whatever it is. They're willing to do anything to stop that puck. And right there, Bombers putting on relentless pressure. But the Battle First North Stars doing a great job of getting in front and just putting their body on the line.
Big shot block. Metternach deserves a real high five from his teammates for a couple of big shot blocks. Cunningham getting the helmet all reorganized. He'll be ready. 16 seconds to go in the power play. 12:58 to go in the third period. Puck went back in front to a big power play goal here by Justin Lee. It's back to Hull. Hull races and then a shot. Great glove save, Cunningham. That's the 11th shot for Flintbomb already in the period. And we haven't even played 8 minutes so far in the final frame.
And what a save there by Cunningham. His glove today has just been absolutely on fire.
How about that toe save he made just a couple minutes ago?
I will say very impressed. We talked about how good he was going to be, but absolutely unbelievable today, Rob. Logan Cunningham.
Gruner, the face stop here against Metternach, who, of course, has been great on the penalty kill. Bombers with the draw! Fired on target. Speaking of the glove, there it is again, Anderson. Right on the tape, he let her rip, and Cunningham flashing the leather once again here with a couple seconds remaining here on this power play.
All great shot opportunities here by the Bombers. Not a single bad shot's being taken, but Logan Cunningham just putting on a show right now.
6 seconds to go at the power play, 12:48 in the game, a 4-3 flip-flop. Lee Gruner digging in for the faceoff to start with this draw. That's Isaac, and he'll get a hold of it, and he'll send it the length of the ice, and picked up by Tanchuk, that'll do it for the power play. Flintfawn, 2-for-5 in the game. Here comes Anderson flying up the ice. He'll get a hold of it. He'll flip it in. And Cunningham had to go over and grab it right away. Look out. Isaac comes over, and I think they think that Anderson might have snowed him when he skated in there.
Yeah, I think he might have a little bit.
So Isaac didn't like that. He took a whack at him, but love the faceoff. Flintfawn up to 53 shots. Is that accurate?
I think that may be a little inflated. 53, that's I don't know if you have that much. That may be 45, but
that
you know
what? That seems so much to me, but I don't know. I was never good at math. I'm not the guy to ask.
No, that's why we do broadcasting, Rob, exactly.
They say 53-17 the shots right now on the Trad Realty shot clock. And Flint Bond has retaken the lead 4-3. A big power play goal here by the captain, Justin Lees. They're working over the net right now. The net came flying off, and they're trying to get that back on the boardings. Once again, out of town tonight. Other game is still scoreless, and don't expect a lot of goals, I don't think, in that series with those two elite goaltenders. Nothing, 13 minutes to play in the second period. Melford Humboldt, game one tonight at the Palace, the other SJHL semifinal. Stars get three guys to center. Here's Blake across the line, hangs off, throws it up front, and hit a skate. Olsen can't pick it up. It comes in front of the net, grabbed here by Niven. And Niven will bounce it off the boards, up the middle. Look out, Olsen almost got free. Comes back to Egan. He'll get a hold of it and flip it back in. Portner picks up the puck back of his goal. Two power play goals for him tonight. Portner to center, falls down. That's offside. And Blake got a little bit ahead of him. And they do blow it down with 11:58 to go in the third period. A 4-3 Flint-Bond lead, but a great atmosphere again tonight. A great hockey game here tonight. And boy, these two teams, I think they bring the best out of each other.
Oh, absolutely. You know what? Just the both hard physical play. And I think in a lot of ways, both these teams are very, very similar when it comes to play style, players, and everything. And they definitely bring the best out of each other.
You're right. The makeup is very similar. Here's McDutt. Plays it back. Yakupchuk intercepted Bergeson. Took it right away from him. Bergeson will bring it in. Yakupchuk tried to tie him up. It goes back of the goal. Puck bounces. Joey Lees will pick it up for the Bombers. They'll lift it ahead. Looking for Gruner. He can't grab it. Intercepted at the battle for blue line that time by the D-man Granger. They'll play it back in flip one territory. Yakupchuk will flip it ahead. Knocked down at center ice by Grill. Lees was behind him, and Grill made a great play, and he'll knock it in. Yakupchuk again. Up the boards. Once again, he can't clear. Bergeson out front. Lees tries to come in to help. You got to get that puck out of the zone. Shot blocked here. Picked up by Gruner. He'll get it back to center. He'll dump it in and go off for a change, and back to pick it up is the veteran D-man Grill. He ran into a little bit of trouble here with a good forecheck by Piccinino. Anderson back in there for the Bombers. Knocked it down, comes out front. Nobody could get a stick on it. Stars get it. That's sent back to center. Anderson back to get it for Flint-Flon. Trying to lift that one ahead. Intercepted. Getzlaff back across the Bomber line. Getzlaff. Bouncing puck, laying inside the Flint-Flon zone. Pinned up along the board, starts to get free. Boy, Getzlaff, he just doesn't give up. Lepper will get a hold of it. He can't clear it out. Stars hold it in. Good pressure here by the North Stars. Noah Hull inside his own zone, lifting up the boards. He gets it out. Carmen will pick it up, and he'll drill it right back in. The Stars will make changes down to 10.5 to go in the third period. Lepper stuck behind his own net, swings the pass to Hull. He'll drop it back to Bachler. Bachler to carry it center, puts the pass ahead to Anderson. He's across the line. Tried to feed it out front, but got pinned up. Isaac comes back for the Stars. Isaac down the wing, across the Bomber line, goes in, fires it over top of the Bomber net. Buckler gets it out. Anderson to center for Flint-Flon. Carter Anderson across the line. Dumped it in deep for Sepp Buckler in front of the net. Sepp, though, had no idea where he was. Pinned up in the corner. Flint-Flon tried to work it free. It goes back to the goal. Isaac is there. He's going to skate with it. Brings the pass to Williams at center. Williams will flip it in. There's backs for Flint-Flon, back inside his own zone. Williams steals it, throws it out front, but knocked away. Good defensive play by Tatcher. Bachler away again. Back to Sepp at center. Firing it in with Gilbert in pursuit. Olsen slapped it away from him, got it back to center ice. Olsen, he gets the steal. Olsen, in alone. Olsen, backhander, what a save! By Logan Cunningham, Kylan Olsen beats the D-man. Gets in with a great backhander, but Logan Cunningham... Another big save. Media timeout. We take a break. Flint-Flon in front by one here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintflonOnline.com. What a stop.
Clear.
And play two.
It's the stomping and the whining that I struggle with. Crazy family home I have is perfect, but for the stomping and the whining. I'm sorry, son. We are watching Dad's big game and then our movie. You'll have to use the old TV in the basement for your games. No good. What do you mean, no good? Okay, okay. I'll see what we can get for you and your friends at Shane's. Great news. Shane's carries a variety of Skyworth Google TVs made with affordability and decent graphics and sound in mind. Easy to use, pairs with your kids' tech, and you'll be happy with the price. Find Skyworth TV options at Shane's at the Attunique Mall and get rid of their stomping and your whining. Shane's. Watch, listen, play, connect.
And a brutal hit into the boards. That sent Shockwaves through the ring.
They'll need to be sent for shockwave therapy at full range therapy in Creighton for sure.
Pain reduction, restoration of movement, that's just what's needed here.
With stem cell activation accelerating the healing of bone, muscles, and tendons.
Better call or go online for an appointment because Shockwave is ideal for everyone who battles everyday and injury pain.
Win the pain game against chronic headaches,
10 seconds,
arthritis, neck, back pain, and more. Book a Shockwave appointment with Mark at FullRangeTherapy.com. Your transformation awaits.
Yep.
And welcome back to Lit Forum. The puck will come out. Bombers dump it back in. Here's a pass up the left or right side for Blake. He's across the Bomber line, throws it out front, and the puck will make his way in the front of the net. It's grabbed and held onto here by Harmon Laser-Hughes. Spencer Bell has got to start in the playoffs. Humboldt scored. They're up 1-0 on Melford midway through the second period. Spencer Bell, of course, 47 in the regular season.
Boy, it looks like he was getting close to 50 there near the end of the season in those past couple games against the Bombers, but how exciting to watch him play.
So Spencer Bell scored. Broncos lead the Mustangs 1-0 midway through the second period tonight. Connor McDonald's out of town scoreboard. That's just the second shot of the period for Battleford. Went by not shooting at 13-2 in this period, 54-18 in the game. And a faceoff once again in Flint-Flon territory. They win the draw. Niven stretch pass to Egan. He'll chip it in and he'll come barreling down after it. Egan races in. Got a piece of back of the goal before he got knocked down. And puck is picked up on the Stars. There's Key and Bell up the left side. Bell across the Bomber line. He'll hang on a shot. He ripped it over top of the net. Puck will come out. Rolls back in Battleford territory. Gold back to get it. Here's Tanner Gold, the Battleford captain, inside his own zone. Up the left side. Puck hits a few players, so ice will be negated to roll in. Laser-Hughes stopped it back of the goal. Puts it around the Gruner. Blindly throws it up the middle of the ice. Intercepted by Anderson and sent back in. 8:22 to go in the third period. Noah Hull back of his own net has got it. He's going to take his time. He's watched out front. Now he'll dish it off to Leppard. Gets back to Carroll. He'll dump it down. Icing against Flint Flon. 8:09 remaining. And all these faceoffs now gigantic, especially. Usually I say they're bigger in the offensive zone, but when you have the lead, they're bigger in the defensive zone.
Oh, absolutely, because you don't want that pressure on you. It's a... Like you mentioned, every face-off is huge right now. And like I said, I think it's been pretty 50-50 across the board. But you know what? It all comes down to this last period. And right now, the Bombers need these.
They do. Face-off inside Flint-Flon territory. The Stars trying to jump on it. Puck is laying there, picked up by Lees. Can't clear. Held in here by Isaac. But he gives it away to Carroll. Carroll's got it. He'll get it to center. He'll lift it in. Isaac will go back. Expect Isaac to be on the ice almost the last 8 minutes here. Austin... going through his 50-50 numbers. If he disappears here tonight, you'll know that he won it. He will come back for tomorrow night, right, Austin?
Oh, of course. Always, Rob.
Puck laying inside the Flint-Flon zone. Justin Lees will play it ahead to Anderson on his side of center. Here's Anderson. Stick handling it. He'll bring it back in his own zone. Not sure what he's trying to do here. But he backpedals back deep in his own end. Played it ahead to Justin Lees. Justin Lees forced back as well. Now they'll play it ahead. Back's got tied up with the official. And the play gets blown down here. That's always dangerous when you backpedal and go back in like that.
Yeah, no, and the Bombers got to be careful and not playing too timid right now, and that's kind of what a lot of teams run into at any level is when you find yourself up, you don't want to attack too much because you don't want to put yourself in a vulnerable position, but at the same time, you don't want to be too timid and back off because then you give easy chances for the opponent as well.
Walker wins his face-off outside the Bomber line. They've got it. Tanchuk will get that ahead to Semp, and he'll poke it in. Racing after it, here's the North Stars, Carmen. They're going to announce 50-50 numbers, but I think they already flashed them on the screen. You didn't win, I take it.
I got the first two numbers, so...
That's better than what I normally
do. That's what I'm saying. I'll take the small victory.
Gold back of his own net. Somebody's going to walk out of here with a pretty happy person. Gold up the middle. Chip deck into Flint-Flon territory by Elijah Anderson of the Stars. Bax has got it for Flint-Flon. He'll carry it out. Here's Bax up the middle of the ice. Dumped it in off the glass with Gilbert after it. Gilbert... chases his guy down back of the goal. Semp can't knock it down. Comes to the line. Held in by Yakupchuk. He raced over there. Alert play by the young Bomber D-man. Wachler tried to feed it back. Intercepted this time by Waldy. He'll lift it ahead. Buck bounces in Flint-Flon territory. Played back here to McNutt. Here's Yakupchuk off the boards to Vockler over top of his stick. Picked up Piccinino. A chance off the blocker that time. Of Cunningham. Big body check there. As Anderson able to take it away from Medernack. Stars do clear it out though. Williams looking for Medernack. Almost got him. Flip one just got it out. Williams will jump back on it again. This brother Williams, a terrific looking first year player. Justin Lee's banned on it. Taken away. Set back in. McNutt. Back of his own net, fighting to get it away, but the Stars with that ferocious forecheck will take it away from him. McNutt tied up at the corner, lost his stick. Puck dug free here by Anderson, then it goes back into the pile. Williams will dump it back in. He's the one that started the whole play. Chance for Sinclair! Look out, he takes Laser Hume's mask off with that shot. And boy, the battle for Stars, we talk about, of course, the elite players of Portner, Bell, Isaac, but they got a lot of good, aggressive young guys that do not give up.
Oh, absolutely. And I think that's why, you know, the Bombers and Battlefords are such a great matchup, because they both have those guys down the depth, doesn't matter which line, that they will fight and they will fight. They'll play hard. They play aggressive. And that's why these two teams, it's so exciting to watch, because both teams all the way down the depth chart have guys who are willing to put their life on the line.
Face off inside the flip one zone. They'll rim it around the boards to Divot. He can't clear it out. Stars hold it in. We're down to 5.5 remaining in the third period. Niven again. Once again, can't get it out. Puck sent in on target. Glove save made. Flintbond struggling inside their own zone. They can't play around here. They've got to get that puck out. Even if you ice it, who cares? Get it out of your zone. Olsen holds it in to Isaac. Banned on it. Pushed it ahead. Leper can't get to it. Fool. He's knocked off the play. Portner. Olsen takes a run at him in the corner, tied him up anyway. Portner, though, like I said, these guys don't give up. The Stars get the puck back again. Bell to the blue line. Held in by Olsen. Through traffic, knocked out in front by Blake, and finally picked up by Hull. He'll skate with it. Blake's hurt. He took the puck up high. Long shot into the glove. Cunningham to save. Isaac will grab it down to 4:41 in the game. Isaac lifts it back to center. Knocked away by Joey Lees, but quickly taken back here by the North Stars, Bergeson. He'll drop it back to Olsen. Here's Bergeson down the wing. He got pancaked that time by Bax. Bax will play it ahead. Nice pass. Joey Lees has got it. Full flight across the Battleford line. Lees is backhander off the side of the goal. Joey Lees to the blue line. Bax gets it off his stick and comes back to center. He'll lean into it and fire it in now, and it's going to roll around the boards and clear the zone. Back to center. Tanchuk will rip it in on target. Save made here. Like Cunningham. Brunner holds it in. Back out front. Carroll stop. Shot. Oh, he had Cunningham leading the wrong way, but it got redirected and never made it to the front of the net. Bergeson's still out there for the North Stars. He'll flip it in and go off for a change. And gloved and held onto by Laser Hume with 3:49 to play in the third period.
And Bombers almost find themselves in some dangerous territory, having the puck caught up a little too much in their own
They're
zone.
They're playing around. You know what? Like I said, I mean, I guess it's easy for me to say, but even if you have to ice it off, you got to get the puck out.
No, exactly. You can't have a team like Battleford who's got a strong, strong forecheck giving you that pressure for 3 or 4 minutes straight. That's where you're going to find yourself in the bad position. So I agree, Rob. You got to get that puck out of there. Even if you ice it, at least give yourself 10, 15 seconds to regroup. You get a draw on your own end, and gives you a 50-50 chance to get that puck back.
Trad Realty shot clock says 56-21 Flintbond tonight. Bombers at front 4-3. I'll tell you what, the Stars have they've given Flintbond everything they can handle again. Here's Anderson for Flintbond 1-on-1 here against the veteran grill. Anderson to the outside out front. Lees for the hat trick, and that got blocked in front that time by the D-man Rask. Oh, a beautiful setup again by Anderson and Lees. Lees a pair of goals tonight, and was in perfect positioning there. They're offside, they'll touch it. What a play by Carter Anderson.
Yeah, you know what? And he's one of the best skaters on this team and in the league.
Absolutely.
And right there, just proving it. Absolute power skates down. Tries to get the corner, can't get it, but uses his momentum, his balance to send that pass back. Beautiful pass to Justin Lees. Looking for the hat trick, just can't get it to go, but a great setup. And those two have the chemistry all year.
Face off outside the Battleford line. Flintbond trying to jump on it, throw to the blubber blue line. Grabbed here by Leper. He'll poke it ahead. Waiting for it here is Grill. And he'll send that one back over to Gold. Gold, big pass, but knocked away by Gilbert. Overskated him and picked up by Bachler. He'll get it in deep. Bachler rims it around the boards. Picked up here by Porter. Up the middle, look out. Bell almost got away. That was close. He's just so good at getting in behind defenses. Here's Poole. Pass to Gilbert. Gilbert for the Bombers to center. Back across the Battleford line. He'll carry it in. Stott shoots. That goes wide. Knocked away that time by the D-man Grill. Blake comes back to get it. 2:45 to go. Blake. Up to Grill. Intercepted by Olofsson. Olofsson shovels the pass to Hull. Hull grabs it at center. And he lifts it in. Grill back to get it with Egan on top of him. Grill loses it out front. Olofsson with a steal. A shot chipped away by Cunningham. Good grab at center ice here by Anderson of the Stars. Anderson down the lane. Carries it in. A shot. He almost beat Laser Hume. It was through his legs and just missed. Egan back the other way for Flint Pond. Feeds it back to Niven. Niven to center will dump it in. Just over two to go in the third period. Flint Pond in front 4-3. Niven can't hold it. Anderson for the Stars. Dumps it back in deep. McNutt better hurry. McNutt will knock it down. I think he thought it might have been an icing call. He stopped, but he'll feed it ahead to Egan. Egan by himself to center. Long shot kicked away. Picked up here by the North Stars' Isaac. 1:50 remaining in the game. Lost the handle, but goes back to get it. Across the line, scored by Piccinino. Piccinino in deep, shoots it. Save here. Puck is loose in front. They jab away. And finally grabbed here by Cunningham. An uncharacteristic, an icing giveaway here. Maybe trying to do too much, Austin, here in the late stages of the game.
No, absolutely. You know what? When you feel that pressure and time's kind of crunching down, you start to kind of have second thoughts about what you're going to do, and that's kind of what happened. Has a second thought, bad turnover. Like you said, not very characteristic. And right now, Brayden Klimoska, while I was watching Cunningham, Rob, second the puck would touch the neutral zone, he was looking to leave but just couldn't get it. And so expect to see Logan Cunningham out of the net very, very soon.
1:38 to go. I'm almost wondering if Battleford's going to call a timeout here. Doesn't appear they are. Justin Lees is having a conversation here with the referee about something. But again, we talk about these big, big face-offs here, Austin. Biggest face-off of the game, obviously.
Oh, 100%, and they need it. And like I said, you know what, if Battleford wins this, the second they bring it to that neutral zone, expect Logan Cunningham to be leaving that crease.
Hochler against Pedernak, and the Bombers get it in deep. Niven tried to tie it up. Racing it is Olofsson for football. Boy, what a performance he's had tonight. Grill will get it in the corner. Grill the veteran. Look at him carry the puck out. Look at this. Grill the center, dishes it off. The Stars get it in. There's a shot ticked away by Laser. He'll rebound, comes right out front. Nobody there, and Cunningham has to go back in. Walker racing down the ice. He'll pick it up. Walker racing it down the lane. Shoots it, and that one goes wide. Pedernak might have got a piece of it. Lentzbaum will hold it in for the time being. Olofsson gets a stick on it, comes back to center ice. Pedernak, he'll pick it up and flip it back in Battleford territory. Grill's got it. Cunningham wants to come out. He's halfway out. Stars will throw it in. There he goes for the extra attacker. Less than a minute to go. Up the board, Justin Lees is out there. You want him out there if there's any late faceoffs.
And Cunningham's gone.
He'll dump it in. Isaac had the puck roll on him. Anderson after it in the corner. Back out to Lees. Lees knocked it down, loses his stick. All kinds of tie-offs. Piccinino will pick it up, flips it back to blue line. Puck picked up here by McDuck to the empty net. And that's blocked here by goal. Isaac has it 30 seconds. In the game at center, he'll rip it in. Laser Hughes stops it back and then up the board. Puck is grabbed here by Porter. Porter back of the goal. Porter trying to come out front. In a stick, Porter gets it back the blue line. They fan on it. They get it back up front. Bombers can't grab the puck. Will come outside the zone. Grill goes backward at center. Pokes it back to Porter. Porter trying to get it to free. Here's Key and Bell. Trying to come back. Knocked down by Anderson. And the Bombers are going to win game one.
exactly. People always like to look at the scores, who gets the points, who gets the goals. But at the end of the day, you win games by heart, the nitty-gritty, and the how badly you want to win. And tonight, you can see that with guys like Olofsson, Egan, Riley Niven, Pitt Cimino, Dawson Carroll, everyone on this Bombers team tonight, regardless if they scored or not, they had the will to win, and they had their foot on the gas the entire time.
They're going absolutely insane here. Anyway, the Bombers hang on for a very hard-fought 4-3 victory. Justin Lee's the captain, the power play goal, the difference. Let's take a break, Austin. We got a lot to get to tonight. Final scoring summary. We got the post-game show awards, and of course, the Great North post-game report. But boy, the crowd is in a frenzy for sure. The Bombers do something tonight they couldn't do last year. That's beat the Battlefords in a playoff series. They got swept at all four straight games last year.
No, absolutely. And that's a perfect start. You know what? When in playoff series, you always want to try and get the split. The Bombers got that, cross it off the list. Now tomorrow, they want to come back and try and get the second one. But getting this first one, like you said, is something they weren't able to do last year. So a huge step in the right direction for the Bombers. And now through the battle for its North Stars Bowl. Big credit to Logan Cunningham. He played.
Yeah.
If you're Braden Filosco, I don't think you could ask for more from him, honestly. Great game from him. I think Battleford's had to get more shots on net. That's where they really struggled.
From better areas.
Exactly. But you know what? Bombers had control for 80% of this game. And you could just tell the physicality, the scoring, the shots, the flow of the game, just overall. The Bombers outplayed Battleford without a doubt today. And they got the result they deserved, the 4-3 win.
Let's take a break. Lots still to come from the Whitney Forum tonight here on 1029 CFAR and FlintFawnOnline.com.
Claire, what is that noise?
13. Just a little rusty.
Dude, that's not good. You should probably get that fixed.
Ah, who cares?
You should. You know that having a properly installed overhead door can help protect your home against extreme weather and help you save on your energy bill?
What? I didn't know that. What should I do?
Call Jim's Custom Doors and Windows, 687-7071. From the installation of a new overhead door to the repairs of an old one, their trusted technicians have you covered. Jim's Custom Doors and Windows, wishing the Bombers the best of luck during the playoffs.
Hud Bay is proud to be a sponsor of this Bomber broadcast. From donations for bursaries, hockey schools, clubs, community events, charities, and so much more, Hud Bay has supported our community with dedication and generosity, contributing to events and organizations. Hud Bay thanks the people of Flint Fawn for their continued support.
Lunch is short, so get as much flavor and freshness as possible from the North of 53 Co-op. A comforting sandwich on fluffy, soft bread, a crisp, refreshing salad, or sushi to share, or not. And while you're there, take care of everything with a ready-to-go meal kit. Available in chicken or fish taco, Greek pita or pizza, made in-store by the talented co-op staff. Lunch done quicker, supper made easier, both made fresher. At the North of 53 Co-op, you're at home there.
RAG 1987 Limited in the Paw now have ultra-quiet generators in stock for any purpose. The ultra-quiet 1000i is one of the quietest gas-powered generators on the market, delivering 1,000 watts of power. The 3000iES features the Honda Eco throttle system, offering amazing fuel efficiency, lasting 7 to 20 hours on a single tank. From recreation to industrial, get your hands on a Canadian-built and tested Honda generator at RAG 1987. Limited in the Paw, your local Honda dealer.
The spring weather is finally here and you want to be outside as much as possible. But with piles of dishes and a mountain of dirty clothes that love to fight with your old appliances, you may be inside more than you think. That's why you get Maytag at Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center. Maytag appliances make your life easy by doing the hard work for you. No more hours of fiddling, jimmy rigging, or playing with your old appliances to try to get
10 seconds.
Just upgrade to Maytag now with Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center and enjoy that spring weather. 306-688-7587.
You're on.
All righty, welcome back to Whitney Forum. Boy, what an explosive opening night here in the SPHL semifinal. The Bombers hanging on for a 4-3 victory here tonight. Austin, let's run down all the goals as they were scored. Anthony backs. Bombers picked him up. They won that depth scoring from the back end. They needed another big puck-moving D-man, a good offensive D-man. Like I said, gave up a lot to the Dauphin Kings to get him, but a nice big goal for him to start things off in second.
Anderson and Pacino would start things off for Flint Fun early tonight at 3:15. Bergeson, right place. This guy just knows where to be. He took a great feed from Isaac. He went down the ice, down the wing, and he fooled Lays of him. I'm sure that's one that he wants back, but give Bergeson credit. You don't score if you don't shoot. He fired over top of his left shoulder to tie things up at the 12:21 mark, so 1-1 after one. Bombers to jump out early. Matt Egan, what a playoff warrior this guy's been. What an inspiration he's been to his club. He gets in front of the net, pokes the puck free. His second from Olsson and backs at 1:45. But the North Stars have come back. A couple of power play goals by Porter. He'd get his third from Bell and Isaac at 2:52. Porter again from Sinclair and Blake on the power play at 6:31. Stars up 3-2, but a couple of big goals by Justin Lees on the power play. He gets the tying goal here at the 15:30 mark. Fourth of the playoffs from Bachler and Hull. And the game winner, second of the night, fifth of the playoffs from Gruner and Anderson at 5:18. Bombers hold on the rest of the way, winning at 4-3. Got 18 shots that third period. They outshot the Stars 18-6. The Bombers 59 on net tonight compared to 22 of the Stars. Both power plays are good, Austin. I mean, Battleford's got to be happy 2-3. And the Bombers wind up 2-5, which is interesting and big for them because the first couple power plays tonight, as we know, didn't go according to plan. They really couldn't set up. They looked almost confused, puzzled a little bit. They're going down the ice. They didn't really know. But they got their mojo back, and just the captain has had a tremendous year. You know, he didn't win a year-end league award. I think he should have. He's been a tremendous player for the Bombers in all kinds of different aspects. But, boy, when they needed their captain most, Austin, two big goals tonight with the game winner on the power play. Another fine performance from number 23.
Well, you know what? And he's not a captain for no reason, like you said. Not only on the ice, but off the ice. Such a leader. Comes in those big moments. Hometown kid. And exactly the type of person that needed to put the team on his back today. And he did. Two huge goals. And like you said, Matt Egan. Huge goal for him to kind of get the momentum swinging in the Bombers' way. But also, like you said, got to give credit to the Battleford North Stars. Logan Cunningham played unreal. But Ben Portner, well, what an absolute offensive weapon. But one thing I think the Bombers did a great job today was containing Kean Bell. You didn't really hear his name too much, which is, you know, if you're the Bombers, that's a great thing because he's a very lethal scorer, and they did a great job of containing him. But now the next step for the Bombers is you got to watch those next guys down the depth chart because just because you stop him, now you got to worry about Portner, got to worry about Gold, and the huge other list of scores that they got. They did a great job of doing it today, but Ben Portner, got to give the flowers to him because what a performance from him. But Justin Lees was really the standout for today.
Well, and I think Battleford will have better legs tomorrow too, right? Weren't moving their feet as much here tonight. I mean, give them credit. I mean, I'm sure they tell you probably not their best effort in the playoffs, but they still almost won the game. Yeah, I expect it to be a lot better tomorrow night, and football can't afford to sit on the puck in their own zone. Going to need some timely saves, and are probably going to have to bring it up a notch to win tomorrow. But you take it game by game. Battle for the defending Canterbury Sea Cup champions. So somebody beats them. So a good start for the Bombers, who, like I said, got to have momentum. They couldn't beat them in the playoffs. Well, nobody could. And they got Weyburn did fluke off that one victory early last year, and they reeled off everybody in pretty short order after that. So it got to be a big confidence builder, right?
Oh, absolutely, especially in the Bombers. This, like I said, they needed this win. This first game is always important, especially at home. But you know what? Being critical, that obviously wasn't a perfect game for the Bombers, especially down the stretch near the third period. Like you said, holding the puck a little too much in their own zone. A lot of blind passes right into the middle of the ice in their own zone. Not the stuff you want to do. A little rush, you know, kind of second thoughts, kind of stuff like that. But rather than that, very clean game for the Bombers. And like you said, that's the momentum they needed. But I think the Bombers got to be ready. They got to step it up. They got to be ready for an even more difficult, harder, fast-paced, and stronger Battleford's team that they're going to see tomorrow because Battleford is definitely going to be come out swinging.
All right, and the head coach, Jim, is on his way up to the booth. We'll take a break and come back with him momentarily. Bombers win game one, 4-3. Justin Lees again, the power play marker, and a local hero tonight strikes with not one, but two goals, a tying goal, and, of course, the game winner as well late here tonight as the Bombers steal this 1-4-3 on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFunOnline.com.
When you open sparkling water, you're not just opening a refreshing drink, you're opening a world of possibilities. How about a nice Hawaiian vacation? Or an amazing African safari? Or even a not-so-fun trip to the Amazon? When you have a bubbly, sparkling water, you can go anywhere and do anything. So crack a smile. Arctic beverages and bubbly, sparkling water.
Lunch is short.
So get as much flavor and freshness as possible from the North of 53 Co-op. A comforting sandwich on fluffy soft bread, a crisp refreshing salad, or sushi to share, or not. And while you're there, take care of everything with a ready-to-go meal kit. Available in chicken or fish taco, Greek pita or pizza, made in-store by the talented co-op staff. Lunch done quicker, supper made easier, both made fresher. At the North of 53 Co-op, you're at home there.
Hudbay is proud to be a sponsor of this Bomber broadcast. Through bursaries, donations for hockey schools and clubs, community events, charities, and so much more, Hudbay has supported the Flin Flon community with their dedication and generosity for decades and continues to be a major donator to charities, events, and organizations. Hudbay thanks the people of Flin Flon and the surrounding communities for their continued support.
And a brutal hit into the boards. That sent Shockwaves through the ring.
They'll need to be sent for shockwave therapy at Full Range Therapy in Creighton for sure.
Pain reduction, restoration of movement, that's just what's needed here.
With stem cell activation accelerating the healing of bone, muscles, and tendons.
Better call or go online for an appointment because Shockwave is ideal for everyone who battles everyday and injury pain.
10 seconds.
Win the pain game against chronic headaches, injuries, arthritis, neck, back pain, and more. Book a Shockwave appointment with Mark at FullRangeTherapy.com. Your transformation awaits.
You're on.
And welcome back here to the Whitney Forum tonight. Mike Reagan is ready to go here with the Great North post-game report. Mike, what can you say? A hard-fought 4-3 victory here tonight. And you scored early again. I guess if you want to take something out of the Kindersley series, you seem to get goals early each game. You did that again tonight. Must have been, was it, did you feel a big jump on the bench when Back scored 3:15 in?
Yeah, what a play. You know, good for Back. He's got such a great shot. He's so dangerous when he uses it. And, you know, to get us going there, it was a nice little play. You know, at the blue line there, and, you know, he had, I don't know, the seas parted for him. So, you know, that's a big goal for us. You know, you're not sure how you're going to come out, you know, with that layoff and the pressure of being at home and stuff like that. And I thought we were real good tonight.
Well, we talked about it, Mike, as we were waiting to get back on the air here tonight. How about the play of Olofsson, Niven, and Egan tonight? Those guys were absolutely explosive.
Yeah, best line tonight. You know, those guys were dogs, and they just grinded all night, and, you know, Eats comes up with a big goal for us, and, yeah, just, you know, the little things that they do away from the puck, it's, you know, I don't want to beat a dead horse here, but, you know, we talked about Nibs, you know, early on and stuff like that, and we know what Nibs brings to his team, and it's all the little things. He was so good on the wall, made a great play on, you know, chipping the puck out into the neutral zone, and you get a great scoring opportunity, and, you know, just leads to a lot, and, you know, every shift he's not cheating you, and I mean none of those guys are. Ole and Eads, you know, same thing. They just play with their hearts, and you know those guys understand what you know competing is and what being a Bomber is all about.
Power play struggled early, Mike, but it got going as the game went on. And the captain, what can you say? He's been a great leader for you. He's done so many things for your team throughout the year. I guess it's kind of fitting he ties the game and against the game winner tonight. Boy, he brought his best, didn't he?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I think that, you know, without Alexi on the power play, I mean, we had to have a bit of a different setup. And
somebody's pretty excited down there, Mike.
That sort of thing.
Did he win the 50-50?
I don't know. Yeah, who knows? But, yeah, I think that, you know, we had to go with a little bit of a different setup and that sort of thing. And, you know, Battleford gave us a different look. And so you gotta make adjustments throughout the game, and we were able to make the adjustments, and you know, hey, it paid off for us, and huge win for us.
It must feel good, Mike. I mean, we talked about Austin and I were talking about this in the booth. I mean, last year we got swept in the league final against a really good team, and they're tough to beat. This Battleford team must have felt really good to get a win off over them in the playoffs.
For sure. You know, I mean, got a lot of tough series against these guys, and you know, I think that. You know, they would say the same thing, a lot of good series, and, you know, it was nice to just kind of pick up where we left off last series there, and I think that, you know, they're going to be better tomorrow night, but I also think that we can be better. I think we can capitalize on some more scoring opportunities. You know, I think that our penalty kill can be a little bit better. The first goal we give up, we have an opportunity to clear it, you know, and we don't get it out, and, you know, it leads to a goal, you know, but... it's a bit of a chess match. You know, they're going to make adjustments after the first game, and so are we. So, you know, it's going to be fun. You know, I hope we have a bigger crowd than we did tonight. I mean, it was nice and loud, but, you know, it sure seemed like over 1,000 to me.
I think there was 1,300 people
in
there.
So,
and I thought it was great. Like, the atmosphere, the crowd was loud again, and that different times of the game that the Sparker club must be exciting. What's it like on the bench when you hear the
unbelievable. Like, it's, and we got four recruits up here right now, and I've said this before, but they absolutely love it, you know, and it's just who we are, you know, and this is a big part of why players decide to come here, you know. You're not going to find this anywhere else. You're not going to find the enthusiasm and the passion for the team anywhere else, and that sort of thing. So no, it's really good. You know, maybe it's because it's a Thursday night, maybe not as many kids, you know, here as normally, but tomorrow night I'm sure it's going to be over that 1,300.
You know, you talk about the enthusiasm, you talk about the love of the team by the fans, Mike, and I mentioned this with some of your players before the game tonight. Look at the exposure and the support you get on the road.
Yeah, no, I mean, we're like you mentioned there on the road, like I remember when we played Melfort in the league finals and then Battleford in the league finals. And
Estevan.
You know, like, we'd have 400 or 500 people coming to those games, and, you know, that's huge for our guys. And, you know, nobody travels like Bomber fans.
Anyway, Mike, one last thing. You talk about adjustments for tomorrow night. You get Alexi Silvestri back.
Yeah, real excited about getting him back. You know, I think he feels really good. He's excited. He's jumping at the bit. All
must be tough for him to sit there and watch this one tonight.
Really tough. You know, I don't recall, but, like, I'm sure that's one of the few times that Alexi has been in the stands for a game. And, you know, all week he worked extremely hard and practiced in preparation here, knowing that he'll be in for game two. And he's another horse that makes it tough on opponents.
Mike, congratulations. Hard-fought 4-3 victory. Good luck back here tomorrow night.
Thanks, Hardy.
Mike Reagan, the head coach of the Bombers. We'll take one last break, come back with our post-game show awards and a wrap-up from the Whitney Forum here on 1029 CFAR and onepodonline.com.
It's the stomping and the whining that I struggle with. The crazy family home I have is perfect, but for the
stomping
and the whining. I'm sorry, son. We are watching Dad's big game and then our movie. You'll have to use the old TV in the basement for your games. No good? What do you mean, no good? Okay. I'll see what we can get for you and your friends at Shane's. Great news. Shane's carries a variety of Skyworth Google TVs made with affordability and decent graphics and sound in mind. Easy to use, pairs with your kids' tech, and you'll be happy with the price. Find Skyworth TV options at Shane's at the Etunike Mall and get rid of their stomping and your whining. Shane's. Watch, listen, play, connect.
McDonald's and Flin Flon wish the Flin Flon Bombers the best of luck the rest of the way now that they're in the SJHL semifinals, and are also excited to announce their cold brew lineup. Cold brew made with Arabica beans that are cold brewed to create that smooth, cold coffee experience served over ice. The lineup includes the French vanilla cream cold brew, the caramel cream cold brew, sweetened cold brew with cream, a cold brew with a sugar-free syrup and cream, and the smooth vanilla soft serve with pieces of milk chocolate swirled together with a delicious flavor of a sweet Cadbury cream egg. Available now at your local McDonald's in Flin Flon. Don't forget, drive-thru open daily at 7 a.m.
Great North GM in the Paw is one of the leading new and used vehicle dealers in northern Manitoba. Equipped with a highly trained and professional sales department, they also have multiple certified trained technicians on site to make sure you get the best service for your car, truck, or SUV at an amazing price. Great North GM. It's always a great day at Great North GM.
Manly Homes provides a ready-to-move home as unique as you and your family. From the expertise of the planning, the quality of the build, to the care of the move, let Manly Homes make your dream home a reality. All customized to fit your needs, they allow you to take the stress out of home construction and spend more time making everlasting memories. Family owned and operated with experiences in the north, visit manly-homes.ca or call 204-903-5220.
Don't sacrifice function for style. With Shadomatic blinds from Jim's Custom Doors and Windows, your home can have both. You'll get the optimal amount of light and privacy you need, and your window coverings will look great. Jim's Custom Doors and Windows is continuously adding more options for you to choose from. They'll ensure your custom
10 seconds.
Shades and shutters are the perfect fit. Just call 687-7071 and hire experience with Jim's Custom Doors and Windows.
You're on.
All righty, welcome back to Whitney Forum. Quickly, Austin Mattis. We'll, without further ado, we'll get to all our post-game show awards. Austin, I guess the Chicken Chef three-star selection, please.
Well, third star, got to be Matt Egan. Unbelievable game for him today. Got the goal in the second period to put the Bombers up to a huge one, a huge momentum swing for the Bombers. Definitely the one they needed. Third star is going to go to Matt Egan. Second star, got to be Anthony Vax. Opens up the scoring today with a beautiful wrister in the top right circle. Beautiful one that also had the assist later on in the game. 2 points for him in a huge, huge game to get the Bombers started off and get the momentum swinging. And then, of course, star number one, none other than Justin Lees. Two huge power play goals, the game winner. I don't know who else it could be, honestly. Unbelievable game for him.
Tying goal, game-winning goal, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So those are three stars. Matt Egan, the third. Anthony Bax, the second. And Justin Lees, the first. Those are your three stars.
Okay, so we got the frontline warrior of the game. Who do you have?
I actually got two people today. Honestly, there's probably about four or five people out there who probably could have deserved it. But today I'm going to go with Anthony Piccinino and Kylan Olofsson.
Yeah, they were
good. Are the warriors of the game today. And like I said, you know what? They just had the foot on the neck. Playing 150% today, Rob, making so many plays. May not have gotten any goals, but still, just huge plays on the puck, ran their lanes, great on the forecheck, both of them. Great defense just all around. Kylan Olofsson and Anthony Piccinino really just stood out to me today so much for their heart, their effort, and their overall physicality and play. Those are your warriors of the game.
Okay, that leads us to what post-game show award, and that is the Shockwave of the game for Full Range Massage Therapy. A lot of big hits tonight. Which one do you want to, or do you want to go with more than one?
You know what? I'm going to stick with one, but like one person had a few really good hits, and that's going to be Carter Anderson. He's really not a guy you see making too many big hits.
Oh,
but
he flies up the ice more like a torpedo.
Oh, exactly. So he's really picking up speed, and the one specifically was the one right here in the first period, Rob, right under us, that big one on Ben Portner, right into the boards here at the blue line. A huge hit by him. So that's going to be the four-range therapy massage crunch of the game, and well-deserved for Carter Anderson. He had lots of other big ones too, but that was the one that really stood out for me.
Sounds good to me. Quickly, McDonald's out of town scoreboard. It's 1-1. Spencer Bell, like we said, picked up his third in the playoffs to open up the scoring here for the Broncos tonight, but the Mustangs have come back, and who else but Ryan Duque, he gets his fourth. So 1-1, that could be a long one here tonight with those two goaltenders. They're just underway in the third period. So again, Austin, thanks for helping out here tonight. Great broadcast. Great win for the Bombers, and should be a great matchup again. He's back here tomorrow night between his two longtime rivals.
Yeah, Rob, well, always a pleasure. And yeah, it's going to be a good one, a great series overall. And like you said, if this is just a little taste of what we can expect for the full series, well, I think we're in for a whole lot more. And I think we're going to see a bit better offensively. Battleford was great today, but I think we're going to see a whole lot more shots, a whole lot more production, a whole lot more pace from them tomorrow offensively. So Bombers got to come out stronger. Battleford is going to come out stronger. They're going to clash, and it's just going to be an overall a great series and a great game.
It certainly will be. For Austin Mattis, our color commentator, Raphael's right back in CFR control. And of course, Mike Reagan and Greg Klamosko, their comments before and after the game. Matt Egan, a Northland Portland Quad Bomber player profile, and of course, down memory lane, Harvey Stewart, the legendary Bomber netminder, our Bomber Legends interview in the second intermission tonight. Of course, Pat Morrison manning the controls for Flow TV tonight. We wrap it up. The Bombers take game one, the final 4-3. Lees, the hometown captain, the game winner on the power play. The difference tonight. Good night from the Whitney Forum.